Illinois State makes its third consecutive trip to the FCS playoffs after a convincing 37-0 pounding of Missouri State last week. Meanwhile, a 9-2 Central Arkansas team tries to bounce back from a disappointing loss to Southland champion Sam Houston State. It's the Redbirds and the Bears, the first round of the football championship series, next. NCAA FCS First Round Football is presented by Northwestern Mutual. Estes Stadium and the Stripes, for the first time ever, play host to the FCS playoffs. The Southland meets the Missouri Valley Football Conference as Illinois State rolls into town to take on the Bears of Central Arkansas. The 24-team field unveiled last Sunday. A look at the brackets. The winner of this game heads to the Pacific Northwest in a matchup against Eastern Washington in Cheney. On the other side, it's two Missouri Valley Football Conference schools, the co-champs North Dakota State and South Dakota State Jackrabbits, a possible showdown in the quarterfinals. And a big welcome to FCS Playoff Football. Sean Kenny alongside 15-year NFL veteran Chad Brown. The excitement is unmatched with the FCS playoffs, and what's so unique about this matchup, the way the two teams got here. For Illinois State, they literally were the 24th team in, while for Central Arkansas, they were that close to being the number 8 seed.
Yeah, for Illinois State, it's a case of not how you start, it's how you finish. Dropped 4 in a row early in the season, won 4 of their last 5, last 3 in a row. On the other side, for Central Arkansas, reel off 8 in a row in the middle of the season, most disappointing loss last week to Sam Houston State, 4 turnovers in the first 6 possessions.
Illinois State lost 2 dynamic offensive playmakers last year in Trey Roberson and Marshawn Copprich. This year, it's been sophomore Jake Colby who has stepped up, and he's playing his best football late.
He is playing his best football late. He was injured earlier in the season, unable to get a lot of practice time in. Now that he's healthy, he's becoming a very dynamic player, standout for the Redbirds, running the football and throwing the football really well.
13 touchdowns, 3 interceptions over the last 4 games. For Central Arkansas, it's all about their defense. They are stubborn against the run. However, they're beat up in the secondary, very thin at safety today.
Yeah, they have the best rush defense in all of FCS, holding opponents under 68 yards. But as you pointed out, that secondary is banged up and will be tested by the Redbirds' Jake Colby today.
Trey Smith, one of the more experienced corners in the country. Illinois State knows what it takes to get to Frisco. They were in the national championship game just 2 years ago. 30 seconds away, they start a new path here in Conway today. Illinois State, Central Arkansas, the road to Frisco begins. Estes Stadium, the setting on this Saturday afternoon, the opening round of the FCS playoffs, Central Arkansas and Illinois State. Let's take a look at the Northwest Mutual planning for success.
Yeah, for Illinois State, it's all about their size up front, taking on a much smaller defensive front for Central Arkansas. Illinois starters on the offensive line go 6'5", 308. For Central Arkansas, they got to run the football. Hayden Hillebrand, their quarterback, is more of a game manager. He's not the type of quarterback you're going to ask to drop back consistently on third down and pass the football. Makes too many mistakes in those situations.
Steve Campbell, in his third year guiding this Central Arkansas program, he has taken them to the FCS playoffs. First time that's happened since the 2012 campaign. It is a long season for these players and coaches, and it all culminates today with the FCS playoffs. This is what all of the programs across the country circle the date for. You want to be playing football Thanksgiving weekend. Illinois State won the toss. They elected to defer, and it will be a shallow kick off the right foot of Sean Slattery. And on the return, the explosive Jatavius Wilson takes it out past the 20, and good starting position for the Bears.
Nice job by Jatavius Wilson making something on that short return. He's the all-time Central Arkansas kickoff return leader for yards and kickoff return. So nice guy to have back there.
The offense is orchestrated by Hayden Hildebrand, the 6'3", 196-pound junior. He's thrown for over 2,600 yards this year, 17 touchdowns. He can run with the football, and Brock Spack told us he is most dangerous when he's moving that pocket, throwing on the run.
On first down, they will go with the ground game, and it's Kashawn Ledet getting two hard-fought yards brought down by Jason Harris.
Jason Harris is a young player for Illinois State, only a redshirt freshman, but they say he's going to be a star and has really been a truly impactful player in his first year starting.
Hildebrand, such a good game manager for the Bears on second and nine. He has all sorts of time. He's going to take a shot downfield looking for Wilson, and it's knocked away at the last second by Coker. Coming over from his safety position, he got a hand in there.
Great job by Coker, the defensive captain. He's really a great player at the FCS level, one of the best safeties in the FCS level. We'll see him get into his back pedal, gets a hand on that football. Nice job by him. I'm sure he would love to have another chance at that football to actually catch it and not just break that pass up.
Central Arkansas stressed the need for explosive plays, and they try to get one early. Hildebrand forced to settle underneath, and there is nowhere to go. Good coverage downfield. Mitchell Breeze had the running back assignment out of the backfield, and it's a quick three and out for the Purple Bears.
I believe that ball was tipped, and the defensive front for Illinois State does a good job getting their hands up. Shows you that a unit is really well coached. If you can't get to the quarterback as far as a quarterback hit or a sack, get your hands up, interrupt his vision, or potentially tip the football.
Patrick Ponder, a second-team All-Southland Conference punter, gets a wobbler away. He felt the heat. Not a real good kick. It certainly won't win pretty points, but it will be effective as it takes that friendly stripe bounce here in Conway. And speaking of the stripes, it is certainly unique as you first take a glance at this stadium, this facility, and the purple and gray, which has been a trademark the past 6 years. They call it the stripes as you take a look at some of the non-traditional field colors. Boise State started it all with the blue. Eastern Michigan has gone all gray. I was at Coastal Carolina last Thursday night with the teal approach. And next week, the winner gets to see the Inferno Red at Eastern Washington. So Illinois State with the football from the 44-yard line. And Colby to the air, wide open underneath. Schnell makes the catch, and then he is driven down immediately.
Nice job by Colby with the football, throwing from one half to the opposite side of the field. It's a far throw, but it was definitely an accurate throw. And we talked about Colby in the open half. He's getting better as the season has gone along. Wasn't healthy, didn't get a lot of practice time earlier in the season, but really in the second half has started to accelerate his growth.
Yes, sustained a shoulder injury early in the year, and that cost him about a month of practice time. He was still gutting it out each weekend trying to play, but the valuable practice time missed. Jamal Towns, part of a busy backfield, an opportunity, Chab. Really, when you look at Illinois State, we could see as many as four different carriers with the ball today.
Yeah, Jamal Towns is the bell cow, so to speak, for this offense. At 5'6", 175, you think of him more of a scat back, but he's definitely effective through the tackles as well.
Redbirds put three receivers to the bottom. Colby from the shotgun on first down. It will be Towns on a misdirection. Jamal Towns up near the 40-yard line, driven down by George Odom. Towns with 100-yard rushing performances in two of the last three games. He's coming up big in the clutch when Illinois State needed the wins late in the year. They were sitting 3-5 in the playoffs. Weren't looking like a realistic opportunity, but Towns and the rest of this offense started to crank it up. And here they are playing in the first round. Second down, Colby zips it far sideline. It's caught. Christian Gibbs with the reception. This will move the sticks a first down.
We've seen two pass attempts for Colby and two very accurately thrown footballs. And also clean pockets as well. We talked about the size advantage up front for the Redbirds versus the Bears defensive front. That's going to be something to watch as this game goes along, particularly if the Redbirds stay on the ground. That tends to wear out a smaller defensive front if the offense has stayed dedicated to the rushing attack.
Illinois State on the move from the 31-yard line. Colby back to the air, feels the heat, lofts it toward the end zone. Caught just shy at the 6-yard line. The tight end, Petkovic. Tyler Williams with the coverage. Oh, wait a second, they're going to say Petkovic did not control it. They're going to say incomplete as we take another look.
Petkovic, he has his hands on the football, but as they're going down, a great job by the Bears defenders ripping it away. Anyway, as you see on the replay, the ball is on the ground as the play finishes up. Petkovic, big, nice, tall target, unable to corral that football and hold it through the ground.
They don't throw it to the tight ends all that much. Here is Corbin through a huge hole, and the big 225-pounder lunges for the pylon, and he stepped out of bounds a yard shy. The redshirt freshman, DeMarco Corbin, goes 30 yards.
We talked about the size advantage up front. Look at the size of that hole that Corbin cuts through. You and I could have ran through that hole together, holding hands. Nice job by Corbin, extending that football, trying to get it over the pylon there. Unfortunately, he was out at the one-yard line. But the job up front by the Redbirds offensive front gets a smaller Bears defensive front. Again, that's going to be a factor in this ballgame.
They bring in Brady Tibbetts to be the lead blocker, and we have a stop.
Bears plays under further review.
And they are going to take a look upstairs, our first replay. It is a Big Sky officiating crew this afternoon, Jim Crowley, the referee. And what they're going to take a look at is the foot of Corbin before he dives to the pylon to try to get in there for six.
Certainly,
did he step out?
Certainly extended the football and made contact with the pylon. We have a chance to see if he steps out. I don't think he's out. I think he gets that foot off of the ground before he steps out and gets the football and hits that pylon. That's going to end up being 6 points for the Redbirds as I see it.
A concerned look on Steve Campbell. He watches his offense go three and out. And then without any trouble, Illinois State marches it down the field, and a review in which we both feel will be overturned, and we think Corbin will be given the six here.
I think so. And Corbin at 6 foot 225, he's not just a short yardage back, as you saw on that run there, averaging almost 5 yards a carry. And then we saw the big fella get elevated and reach the football over the pylon. Impressive effort by him.
Touchdown.
It's the redshirt freshman who gives the Redbirds the early lead.
Well, we are one for one on our officials' challenges.
DeMarco Corbin with his fourth rushing touchdown of the year. And the depth at running back, we talked about it in the pregame. Marshawn Kopperich, the two-time Missouri Valley Conference Offensive Player of the Year, gone to graduation. Who is going to step up this year for Illinois State? It's been a committee. Who's hot? Right now, it's the red hair from DeMarco Corbin. Illinois State firing the opening salvo. DeMarco Corbin's 31-yard touchdown run has put Illinois State out in front of Central Arkansas, 7-0, six plays, 56 yards. Corbin with the touchdown. They had to take a second look at it. Colby goes 2 of 3 on the opening drive for 15 yards. And here the kick goes sailing out of bounds, and Central Arkansas will get the football in good shape.
Kick out of bounds. Number 97, kicking team. Ball we place at the 35-yard line. First down.
Central Arkansas team, Chad, that has been slow out of the gates this year. And you just have to wonder what's in the back of their minds after what happened last week to Sam Houston State. They fell behind early, 17-0. Really before they could blink an eye, they were out of the game. And now here they are, not even 5 minutes in, and they're looking at an early deficit.
They talked about last week how disappointed the guys were in the locker room and how they kind of vowed to put that behind them. But so far it seems as if there's a bit of a hangover from that loss to Sam Houston State.
Second offensive series for the Bears from the 35-yard line. The tight end is Cody Doubts. He lines up as the H-back to the right. This will be Antoine Wells with his first carry, and he runs into Brent Spack, the inside linebacker.
If that name sounds familiar, that's Brock Spack's son, playing middle linebacker. And we talked about that during the conference call with Brock. He said, I just can't wait to be his dad again. It's been fun coaching him, but he's looking forward to just changing the dynamic of the relationship a little bit.
Campbell in his third year with this program. One of the guys he brought with him was Antoine Wells. Wells was a running back at Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College when Campbell was the head coach, and he brought Wells with him here to Conway, and Antoine having a big senior year.
This is one of those situations they were hoping to avoid, a third and long situation with quarterback Hayden Hildebrand. Tends to try to do a little too much in these situations, which can lead to turnovers.
Illinois State rushes only three. Hildebrand floats a dangerous pass, and it is intercepted by the Redbirds. Devontae Harris, one of the top cover corners in the country, able to get his hands on it, and an early turnover for the Bears.
We see Hildebrand staring down his receiver. You give Devontae Harris that much notice where you're going with the football, a great athlete like Harris is going to be able to go up and elevate and get that football. Hildebrand's got to do a better job of looking off his primary receiver, at least giving his receivers a chance. The defensive backs for the Redbirds are going to be feasting all day long on Hildebrand passes if he doesn't look off the primary receiver.
Second interception this year for Devontae Harris, and for the second straight time, Colby starting in good shape from the 45. He'll stretch it out to Towns, and this Bear running defense has been stiff all season. Jordan Tolliver and company, along with Dalvin Simmons in the backfield.
I would have to imagine after that long run by Corbin, they got to the sideline and said, come on, fellas, we only give up 68 yards a game average rushing the football. That one last carry was almost half of that. So I expect a little bit more inspired defensive front for the Bears.
Towns will flank Colby to the right. Three receivers bottom of the screen, and they will run left side with Towns and look at the little guy go out past midfield
to
the 46-yard line. He stands only 5'6". Brocksback calls him Mighty Mouse. He has a huge heart, and he's proven he can take the pounding.
He will run through the tackles, but when you're 5'6", 175, and you've got a big offensive line, it's to your advantage that you can almost hide behind those guys, because it gets difficult for the defense to find you behind those big bodies.
They bring in the big back Corbin for this third and short, along with Tibbetts, the fullback. They go heavy left side. That's the direction for Corbin, and he has a first down and then some. Wrestled down at the 31-yard line as he broke into the second wave.
Yeah. Brock Spack talked about when you tackle Corbin, you are going to feel it. Nice job up front, but then he runs to that initial arm tackle and then runs to almost a second arm tackle, picks up another 4 or 5 yards after contact. If he continues to carry the football, he's going to wear out this defense for the Bears with his downhill rushing style.
Two carries, 45 yards for Corbin. They'll try to add to that total, and he is cut down. Good open field tackle made. Shooting through that time was Garrett Sharp, the backup Sam linebacker. The Central Arkansas defense, number one in the country at stopping the rush, 67 yards per game. And Illinois State having no trouble moving the football in this first period on the ground. Second and eight, Colby is going to throw. Has time, zips it near side, tipped in the air, and it's intercepted. Picked off down the sideline. There is a flag down. Returning it all the way in for a touchdown is George Odom, but will it stand? Contact as the ball was initially tipped, and let's wait and see.
Holding. Defense on an eligible receiver, number one. 10-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Trey Smith with the contact. Steve Campbell, the discussion.
As the receiver was trying to come back to the football thrown by Colby, Trey Smith is holding the receiver, doesn't allow the receiver to get back to the football, but Trey Smith does a good job of tipping it up. But prior to that, he was holding on to the receiver. Easy call for the officials. When they see those jerseys being tugged, they're going to throw that flag.
The hold happening before the ball arrived. He was jostling with Anthony Warham.
And Anthony Warren was trying to come back to that football. It was a little underthrown by Jake Colby. But Trey Smith, like I said, got a hold of that jersey. Didn't allow him to go back and get that football.
Penalties have certainly been a problem for Central Arkansas. They whip it out. Schnell has his second catch on the screen. And Schnell is tripped up at the 15-yard line by Juan Jackson.
We just talked about penalties. 91 penalties come into this game for Central Arkansas. And that's going to hurt you. When you play a quality team like Illinois State, that play was taken away due to a penalty. So they've had over 900 yards of penalties, 91 penalties total for the season. They've got to find a way to clean that up to have a chance in this ballgame.
Eighth year at Illinois State for Brock Spack, the former Purdue Boilermaker, longtime assistant under Joe Tiller. Second and five from the 15 inside the red zone. They will give it to Robinson, and he gives up ground and is thrown for a loss back at the 31. Raphael Garner, inside linebacker, dropping the true freshman from Rockford.
The true freshman has really come on strong late in this season. We'll see on this carry here. Does what a true freshman kind of does, looking to make a play that maybe he could have made in high school just by being bigger and stronger and faster at this level of football. You go backwards as a runner, they typically tackle you in the backfield. That time, the Bears did just that.
Illinois State happy to see a healthy James Robinson. That's his first touch in more than a month. He was injured in the South Dakota game, pulled hamstring. Third down passing situation, Colby under pressure, and he's decked. Sacked back at the 26-yard line by Chris Chambers.
Fifth sack of the year for Chris Chambers. Playing in kind of that buck position at about 230 pounds. We'll see him coming off the right edge. He's kind of maneuvering his way around those offensive linemen. Nice job by Chris Chambers, recognizing that Colby was stepping up in the pocket and going underneath the offensive lineman for the Redbirds to get the sack.
This has been a distance that Sean Slattery has struggled in this year. Just 2 of 5 from beyond 40 yards. This one from 43. Snap down. He has the wind behind him. Does the kick have enough? It does. It sneaks over the upright, and Illinois State settles for 3. The Redbirds have had the football twice. They've scored both times. They lead 10-0. ESPN's coverage of the FCS Championships continue next weekend with second-round coverage on ESPN3. For more information, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 90 NCAA championships. Illinois State back in the playoffs for the third straight year, and the Redbirds looking solid on the road, 10-0, 6:05 to go in this first quarter. Jatavius Wilson 2 yards deep in his end zone. Wilson lit up the scoreboard in his 4 years here at Conway on kick returns, but this time he's all bottled up and fails to reach the 20-yard line.
Nowhere to go with that football. You're able to kick the football off and get a tackle inside the 20. In my playing days, you got a T-shirt for that. You get a tackle inside the 15. I'm not sure if you get a trophy for that great job by the coverage units for the Redbirds pinning the Bears back here.
Not a good start for Hildebrand. This offense still looking for their first down. He's coming off the interception he threw on their last possession. Hildebrand, a play fake, bootlegs left, throws underneath to his running back. It's a minimal gain as he hits Kelton Warren. Brent Spack was right there.
The Bears just need to get a first down, get some type of continuity going, a little bit of rhythm going so far with the first possession being a 3-and-out, and that last possession with an interception. Been tough sledding for the Bears offense.
Second down and 10 from the 13. That's Wilson in motion, and he will get the call on the jet sweep, and here comes the flag. Like some movement.
False start. Offense, number 40. 5-yard penalty remains second down.
Mistakes early for the Bears.
And there we go, another penalty. One of the most heavily penalized teams in FCS. That's already 2 costly penalties. That play, I think, had a chance to pick up a few yards, but the false start on the tight end pins him back again.
How aggressive do you play it here if you're Central Arkansas? You're working in a very dangerous part of the field. Hildebrand is going to throw from his own end zone and power pattern, and the receiver blew a tire. As he was making his cut, Roman Gordon went down. Rashane Glass the coverage, and it's third and long.
Well, when you've got a quarterback like Hildebrand, to answer your question about how risky do you get, he's been a guy who's tried to do too much a little bit this season. You would hate to have another interception, particularly at this place on the field, which would at least be 3 points for the Redbirds, possibly another touchdown.
Third down and 15. The Redbirds rush only three. Hildebrand looking, nobody open, being pursued, and he'll be forced to dump it incomplete. He heard the footsteps of Matt Swain, and it's a three and out for UCA.
So two three and outs out of their first three drives, and that one was particularly dangerous because once a quarterback goes back into the end zone, if any of the offensive linemen get called for holding, it becomes a safety. And there were a couple of Redbird defenders who were beating their guys, and I was afraid there was going to be a holding call, another penalty, and possibly 2 points for the Redbirds.
Patrick Ponder on the punt for the second time. Schnell awaiting the kick near midfield. Line drive, returnable kick. Schnell will signal for the fair catch at the 45. It's a punt of 37, and for the third straight time, Illinois State in good starting position. Brock Spack's Redbirds lead by 10. Some post-Thanksgiving dancing here in Central Arkansas. Conway, Arkansas, trying to burn those calories after the big feast a couple of days ago.
Absolutely, absolutely.
If you're Illinois State, do you take a shot downfield with Colby in this situation?
I think in the next drive or two, they will try to throw the ball over the Bears' heads, but so far the running game's been working. Why risk it at this point?
Colby on first down, wants to go deep. He's looking for Gibbs, and it's deflected away, incomplete. Good coverage by Odom.
Of course, as soon as I say that, they do throw the ball a little deep. But as an offense, if you continue to run the ball effectively, the secondary and the defenders for Central Arkansas are going to start to creep up, and their first step is going to be forward to deal with the run game. Once you see that as a coach up in the booth, that's when you signal down and say, hey, now it's time to go deep. Central Arkansas, they gave up 10 plays last week to Sam Houston, 16 yards or more. Pass plays of 16 yards or more.
Second down, this is Towns, nowhere to go. He was swallowed up, a loss of three. Dalvin Simmons from his defensive end position, setting up third and long.
This would be a fantastic morale boost for this defense. They're able to stop them here on this third and 13. It would be the first three and out of the game for the Central Arkansas Bears.
Anthony Warren, the dangerous receiver, split to the top, number 82. Colby looks underneath, incomplete. Receiver went down. They were trying to get it to Warren, but tight coverage by Tyler Williams.
And Chris Chambers was coming off his right defensive end spot, putting a little pressure on Colby, forcing Colby to step up in the pocket. Chris Chambers does a good job as a smaller defensive end, squeezing that offensive tackle back, really collapsing that pocket around Colby. Nice job by him, couple series in a row.
A real important stop for the Bear defense. Giving up the football in that good of real estate, Illinois State unable to capitalize.
Yeah, until this drive, the momentum was resting pretty firmly on the sideline with the Redbirds. Now I think the Bears have put a little bit of that momentum back to their sideline.
Reese Adder trying to corner kick it as it bounces inside the five, and it is controlled at the one. Terrific special teams play by Illinois State. That's Brandon Berry downfield for the Redbirds.
The Bears have had very little offensive production, but it's difficult to open up the playbook when you continue to get the football in bad field position. And in this case, pinned back with their backs against the goal line, a potential safety for a sack. A holding call will also lead to a safety if there's a pass play and the quarterback's in the end zone. Again, very difficult to, you know, take chances offensively when you're in this battlefield position.
put the ball at the 4-yard line for Hayden Hildebrand. An ice cold 1 of 6 to start this game with the interception, so they will go to the ground, and DJ Bello is waiting. Nowhere for Keyshawn Ledette. He's met at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, you might want to figure out where BJ Bello is on the field. He's one of those full stat line guys for the Redbirds defense. He's got tackles for losses, he's got sacks, quarterback hits, forced fumbles, passes broken up. If there's a defensive stat, BJ Bello probably has a number in one of those categories.
That is a big transfer from Illinois during the offseason. Second down, they stick to the ground, and again, there's just not much
Ledette
picking
on the
up
carry.
Front. Dalton Keene, Matt McCown, Brent Spack all in
the
attack.
Matt McCown on the stop for Illinois State. It is third down.
Another tricky third down for Hayden Hildebrand. I think running the football, unless they're just going to try to gain some field position for a punt, he's probably going to be out. They're going to throw it here. And again, this is where he tends to get himself into trouble, trying to do too much in these situations.
Third and 6 from the tip of the end zone. He's forced to run, and he is sacked, dumped back at the 8-yard line. Chased down that time by Swain again. That's twice that Matt Swain, the sophomore, has been in the backfield.
Hildebrand had no place to go with the football. It was great coverage by the secondary of the Redbirds. Hildebrand had to tuck it and try to make something out of it.
On the punt for the Bears,
Swain,
number 44,
really good
Patrick
job up
Ponder. Deep to receive for the Redbirds. Number 11, Spencer Schnell.
4 offensive possessions have netted a grand total of 9 yards for Central Arkansas, still searching for their first down. From the end zone, Ponder gets the punt away. Fair catch signaled for by Schnell at the 42-yard line. So for the second straight series, Illinois State gets the ball in great position on the UCA side of the field.
4 possessions so far for Illinois State, and all of them have been in good field position. It makes your job that much easier as an offense. We talked about when Central Arkansas started their last drive, how it's difficult to open up your offense when you're pinned back. You've got the entire offense at your disposal when you get the ball in such great field position as the Redbirds have.
And a drop on the snap. That's a loose football, and I think it's the Bears who jump on it. On the quarterback center exchange, it's the break Central Arkansas so desperately needed.
Absolutely. One of the most fundamental parts of football is the center quarterback exchange. Didn't really get a chance to see what exactly happened. I don't think Colby pulled out too quick from what I could see. He just is unable to corral it. I think the center gets the ball up. Colby doesn't pull out too quick. He doesn't step on someone's foot like you see sometimes. Just unable to cleanly get that football. But a momentum-changing possibility play for Central Arkansas.
Each team has coughed it up once in this first quarter. Inside 2 minutes to go. Let's see if this gets them going. They go to the reverse. Looking for Wilson. He is giving ground. Bello pursuing along with Mitchell Breeze, and it's a huge loss. It almost looked like, Chad, they wanted the reverse pass and give it back to Hildebrand.
That's what they wanted. And so often offensive coordinators love in that situation to go with a big play off that sudden change situation. As for the defense, you're on the sideline, you're drinking some water, you don't have your helmet on. Suddenly says, we're on the field, we got to go. Offensive coordinators like to call a big play like that, catch the defense off guard. That time, Redbirds were clearly ready for that type of play.
Second down and 20. They will fake the little screen to the left. Instead, go center with it. Out of the backfield, Carlos Blackman, the talented true freshman, with his first touch. Still not back to the original line of scrimmage.
Got some of it back. Unfortunately for the Bears, there have been a couple of good plays, but they've typically sandwiched by bad plays around them. They need to, again, develop some rhythm and some continuity and take advantage of, you know, what was really a poor quarterback center exchange by the Redbirds.
Third down and long. Hildebrand settles with a butt hook pattern caught. It's Brady Moore. He'll sprint up near the 49. Drashain Glass able to bring him down well shy of the first down. A decision here for Steve Campbell. They've been pinned down in field position the entire quarter. You don't dare go for it here, do you?
I thought they may, but then also Hildebrand has pooched punt a number of times this season. So if they were to leave the offense on the field, I would expect a pooch punt from Hildebrand, who's actually averaging 45 yards a pooch punt, which is fantastic for a quarterback.
Yeah, three punts this year for Hildebrand. All three times he's pinned the opponent inside the five. This time they will turn to the experienced Ponder to get the job done, and he does. Schnell makes the catch at the 10-yard line with just 10 seconds to go in this first quarter. So, Chad, you look back at the opening 15 minutes, your biggest surprise so far?
My biggest surprise was how cleanly Illinois State came out to start this football game. We knew coming off of last week's loss to Sam Houston, Central Arkansas may be suffering a little bit of the hangover, and it seems like they were, but Illinois State definitely used their size advantage on the offensive front to run the football. Those first two drives was very effective. This is the worst field position we've seen for Illinois State. This could be one of those things where the field flips and now the advantage goes over to Central Arkansas side.
We'll be on first down. We'll give it to Towns, and he is hit at the line of scrimmage on what will be the final play of the quarter. Raphael Garner knifing his way through. And so far, after 15 minutes, Brock Spack's defense, the story, pitching the shutout here in Conway. NCAA FCS first round football presented by Northwestern Mutual. Alongside former NFL linebacker Chad Brown, Sean Kinney with you from Conway, Arkansas. It's been a good start on the road for Jake Colby, as Redbirds with a 10-0 lead. Second down and 9 from the 11. Colby floats, looking for Warm. A little bit too far out in front. Good coverage by Williams.
Nice job by Williams. It would have been a very difficult catch for Worms. Colby could not really step up into the pocket. I think the defense, particularly defensive front for Central Arkansas, is starting to get used to the size of the Redbirds offensive line and starting to be much more effective, particularly in passing situations.
Jordan Tolliver on this defensive line. Tolliver, a first-team All-Southland performer. Cardell Best. They can get after the quarterback. Let's see if they do it here. Empty set for the Redbirds. Third down and 9. They rush 4. They get to Colby. Flush. And he's sacked back at the 4-yard line. Chris Chambers for the second time getting through.
There's that man again coming from the left side of the Redbirds offense. Is Chris Chambers getting around this offensive tackle. A much smaller guy, but we'll see him make contact and then use his speed to chase down Colby, and then does what I call the cheetah tackle. Cheetahs aren't the biggest of cats. They can't just jump on things' backs. They got to trip up their feet. That's what time that's what Chris Chambers did right there.
Two sacks for Chambers today. Central Arkansas, one of the better teams at generating pressure. Reese Adder from the back of his end zone. Line drive kick. He keeps it away from Trey Smith. Takes a fortuitous bounds for Illinois State. And both defenses starting to get traction just how you like it, former NFL linebacker. You don't mind this, do you?
I know college football is all about scoring nowadays, and it feels like if you don't score 38 points, you won't win the football game. But, yeah, there's a bit of an old-time football guy in me who loves to see defenses go out there and make life difficult for some quarterbacks. And after a rough start to the first quarter for the Bears defense, now they're making that rough road for Colby in that offensive line for the Redbirds.
You mentioned rough pass. It has been that so far for Hayden Hildebrand. Trying to change it on first down. He is swarmed, and he goes down back at the 36-yard line. Jason Harris was the closest Redbird as Hildebrand went down without contact.
It's second down.
Sometimes as a quarterback, discretion is the better part of valor. I think Hildebrand certainly wanted to run with that football. We'll see this pocket start to collapse around him, wants to take off with the football, but then he recognizes there's a giant human being cut at me. Let me go down.
Hildebrand takes a shot over the middle, and it's caught. The first down of the game for Central Arkansas. Jaquez McMillian with the catch, able to get in front of Harris.
given a clean pocket, which we see Hildebrand has here, he's able to deliver an accurate football.
Carlos Blackman on the carry for the Bears.
On first down, the up-tempo style, Carlos Blackman. And you see the pace picking up for the Bears. Second down and three, Blackman the call. This time he is ganged up in the backfield. B.J.
Blackman
Bello cutting off his angle. Adam Conley with the initial contact, and it's third down.
Still keeping up with that up-tempo.
Timeout, Illinois State. The first charge half of the half.
Timeout, Red Bears.
Timeout on the field.
So the pacing by Central Arkansas catching Illinois State off guard with the substitutions. The Redbirds burn a timeout. 10-0 Illinois State on the lead, but the Bears for the first time on the march. ESPN's coverage of the FCS Championships continue next weekend with second-round coverage on ESPN3. For more information, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 90 NCAA championships. Big play early in this game for Central Arkansas. Third down, they will stick with the ground game, and there is no hole to be found for Blackman. And a decision for Steve Campbell. Fourth down, and they're looking at three. A short three. Do you try the field goal, get points? Or do you keep the offense on the field in this situation? It looks like they're going to keep Hildebrand out there. A long look over toward the Central Arkansas sideline, and Campbell's going to roll the die. Fourth down, Hildebrand looking left, nothing there. He's going to try to run, and he will move the chains. Dives inside the red zone, and a critical fourth down conversion.
We're seeing more and more of that at college football. Quarterbacks recognize man coverage, see the defenders with their backs turned, able to find a hole in the pass rush and pick up the first down.
Blackman squares up the shoulder pads, leans ahead, runs into Alejandro Rivera. That 30-yard completion has just kind of opened up the Central Arkansas offense. It's allowed them to play a little bit more tempo all of a sudden.
It has, and they can go tempo, but they can also slow it down and go two tight ends, choosing to go tempo with this drive here.
Trying to stretch it over to Wells, and he is thrown down by a good-looking freshman, Jason Harris, the son of former NFL standout Al Harris. He's going to be a good one before he's done in Normal.
Plus a two on the play, it's third down.
Harris out of Barrington, Illinois. Long athletic, went through some growing pains like most freshmen early in the year, but he's come on of late. His dad knew a thing or two about playing defense at the next level.
Absolutely.
Wells stays in the game as the running back. They go two receivers right and left. Hildebrand with a nice pocket underneath and heavy traffic, and it's caught. Wilson hauls it in. First and goal for the Bears.
Again, Hildebrand's got some confidence in the pocket. He can step into his throw. He can be an accurate thrower. I will say number five was rushing around the end there. That was B.J. Bello. That should have been a holding call. No call, but a good football delivered by Hildebrand through a lot of traffic.
They go with their power set. Doubts the H-back to the right. Wells, the running back. He'll try to sprint to the corner, and he is drugged down by Devontae Harris. The cornerback coming in, lending run support.
Yeah, Devontae Harris, we saw him earlier in the game make a nice interception, but he's also a very sure tackler. Does a good job setting the edge for the Redbirds defense.
Stay heavy with the three tight ends and the H-back. Doubs to the right. Play fake. Hildebrand throws underneath, and it's incomplete. He had no time whatsoever. Alec Coker and Mitchell Breeze, the roommates, converging on the quarterback.
So often you hope as an offensive coordinator, when you run that boot pass, that the edge rusher goes down for the run fake. That time, Alec Coker did not fall for the run fake. Was very disciplined in his angle to the quarterback.
Third and goal. Will the third time be the charm for the Bears? Struggling on third downs today. Hildebrand looks. Slant. Wide open. Desmond Smith. Touchdown, Bears.
About halfway through the first quarter, I think we all thought this was going to be a blowout by Illinois State. And momentum was clearly on their sideline. Suddenly the Bears have turned this into a ball game.
Matt Cummins adds the point after the all-time career receptions leader at UCA. Maybe the biggest catch of his career. It gets the Bears on the board in the biggest of stages. .218 career catches for Desmond Smith. That is most in program history. Just an incredible talent from Bentonville, Arkansas. And the senior now just 52 yards away from setting the all-time yardage mark, but it is his touchdown reception on third and goal that's given some life to Central Arkansas.
Yeah, they ran a nice pick route with Jatavius Wilson. Wilson was able to kind of wall off a defender that was responsible for Desmond Smith. Desmond Smith was wide open based on that pick route and a clean football thrown by Hildebrand. And now we've got ourselves a ball game.
An offense that did not pick up a single first down in the opening 15 minutes, able to string a drive together, 12 plays, 57 yards. Hildebrand, the touchdown pass to Smith, and all of a sudden a three-point game.
And what seemed like early on that the Central Arkansas defense would be overwhelmed by the Redbirds offense, after a couple of drives, they seem to have really gotten their footing and are playing some pretty good football.
On the goal line. Good yardage out past the 30, and watch out. Near midfield, finally caught at the 47-yard line by Brandon Cox, but a solid return by James Robinson. And again, he has missed about a month with a bad hamstring, but I'd say that leg's feeling pretty good.
We can see a little bit of a hitch as he's running. I'd imagine if his hamstring was 100% healthy, he might have been able to take this to the house there. But nice job by the true freshman getting his team back into great field position, but more importantly, I think bringing some more of that momentum back to the Redbird sideline.
Colby came out, hit his first two passes, but has since struggled, just 3 of 7. On first down, the delay to Towns, sprints up the middle, watch out. Towns to the 30, covers up the ball with both Jamal arms, Towns and takes it to the 24-yard line. 24 yards on the run by Jamal Towns.
We'll see Towns, nicknamed Mighty Mouse, hide behind a defender. Then after that, it's just his ability to make people miss. Good job protecting the football once it gets into the contact area. You can tell as a senior, he's learned lots of lessons on how to be an effective runner over the years at Illinois State.
Really taking on a leadership role this year with a sophomore, a redshirt freshman, and three true freshmen on scholarship in that running back position this season. Up the middle they go. A little stop and go action by Towns, and then he's met by a trio of purple defenders. Devin Spurlock in there with a bad knee. Spurlock banged up in the game against Sam Houston State. He's one of those safeties we weren't sure if he was going to give it a go today.
Yeah, Spurlock is a big hitter back there for the Bears. But yeah, he's been day-to-day for a couple of weeks. We'll see if at some point his bad wheels are that bad knee, that right knee he's got, that's a lot, doesn't allow him to be as effective, particularly on deep balls.
Second down and 8. Again, it's on the ground. This time it's Corbin, and he just keeps those lower legs churning, and he'll plow inside the red zone, setting up third down.
For Coach Brock Speck, it's such a luxury to have two very different running backs like Corbin and Towns in the backfield, because you can call the exact same play, but it almost to the defense seems as if it's two different plays, because the two running backs with very different skill sets are going to run that play very differently. It really opens up your playbook, but you don't have to teach any more plays.
Illinois State's going to have to hustle. They break huddle with the play clock down to 3, down to 2. Colby gets the snap away, is looking underneath, and he has Towns at the 10. And he is chased down by Garrett Sharp, but not before they move the chains and a Redbird first down.
That's only his fourth reception of the year, so not utilized a lot out of the backfield. We'll see him just running a nice little out route, catches up, turns upfield, picks up the first down. Nice job by Towns.
They send trips left. Towns the lone back. The tight end is Petkovic. He adjusts over to the left side. And the give is to Towns, who finds a little crevice, and he is crafty. Towns takes it to the three, garner the tackle.
I love that word, crafty, but here's a guy, 175 pounds, who has the craftiness to run through the tackles. The replay was great. We saw him make a couple of guys miss, hide behind some offensive linemen. Yeah, crafty is a fantastic word for Jamal Towns.
Yeah, big left tackle, Dan Pawlak, almost stepped on him. He was getting driven back, and then all of a sudden, you see Towns burst through. Second and goal from the three. They bring in the big bruiser, Corbin. Lead blocker is Hendershot, a pullback. He'll try to follow that lead, and the CA defense stiffens. Nowhere to go, Terrence Partee. A big breakout performer this year, Partee with the stop.
A lot of credit to the entire front for Central Arkansas getting that big stop right there. When teams bring a fullback in the game and you kind of know they're going to line up and run the football, it literally just becomes a manhood test of some sort. You know what you're going to do. Now we've got to try to find a way to stop it. That time the Bears stood up to that test.
Warren has yet to get a ball today. He is to the bottom. They go his direction, and on cue, he scores. Anthony Warren with the touchdown. And the Redbirds respond.
Kobe, nice route by Warren, but a nicely delivered football by Kobe. The defender, Tyler Williams, for Central Arkansas, did not have a chance. He's playing with inside leverage. Warren and Kobe recognize that, run the out route. Again, good route. Warren's got great ball skills. Great delivered ball by Kobe.
All set up by the long kick return from James Robinson. Illinois State takes advantage of great field position, and it's Anthony Warren. He put up a record year last season with 15 touchdown catches. He's in double figures in 2016. His 10th haul gives the Redbirds a 10-point lead. Illinois State has never trailed. They lead it 17-7 over Central Arkansas, 5:45 to go here in the second quarter. Anthony Warren put up a record-setting season a year ago. He set the Illinois State school record for single-season reception touchdowns with 15, which was also a Missouri Valley Football Conference high. He's just 40 yards away from eclipsing the 1,000-yard mark for the second straight year. Tavius Wilson with a little bit of a seam. Wilson has some afterburners, takes it all the way out past the 40 to the 41-yard line, a return of 37.
Nice tackle by the kicker, Sean Slattery. If he doesn't make that tackle, I'm not sure if Jatavius Wilson is not going to take this all the way to the house. Pretty good angle by the kicker, Slattery, getting him out of bounds. Big fella was moving. At 6 foot 225, Slattery's not a small kicker.
No, he's not.
We saw Illinois State respond to the Central Arkansas touchdown with a nice drive, particularly led by that return by Robinson. Now we'll see what Hildebrand and this Bears offense can do to respond back.
Reverse pivot. Hildebrand hit as he throws, settles for the tight end Dougs, who makes the initial defender miss, but then Breck Spack is there to lend the support. Spack with the tackle. It's a gain of 5 on first down.
Yeah, Spack is the quarterback of that Bears defense. Knows all the adjustments and checks and makes sure everyone is lined up correctly.
There's the tempo again. A quick hitter to Blackman over the right side. He surges near midfield. About 2 yards shy of the first down. Dalton Keene, Jason Harrison on the tackle.
Yeah, offensive coordinator Nathan Brown for the Bears will insert this tempo part of their offense in and out as he sees fit. They've had games where they've had over 100 plays. They've also had games where they went 2 tight ends and slowed it down. They can do both.
False start. Offense, number 55. 5-yard penalty remains. Third down.
It's on Micah Parton, and that could be a costly one. Third and short now becomes a little bit different. Third and eight.
Well, it's pretty clear that the penalty issues and woes for the Bears have not gone away now that the playoffs have started. They are continuing their high penalty ratio.
Wilson and Smith, the two big playmakers, playing to the bottom on this third down and eight. That's the direction Hildebrand's looking. Smith comes back to the ball, and he has the first down. Nice job that time by Desmond Smith, like all good receivers, coming back to meet the football.
Fantastic job by Smith, but Hildebrand's got a clear pocket. Again, you give him a clear pocket, he's going to deliver a football, but as you point out, great job by Desmond Smith, recognizing the quarterback rolling out a little bit and coming back to meet that football.
Hildebrand with the pocket, throws a wobbler, and it's incomplete. He was hit just as he released it by Conley. Might have altered the throw. He was looking for Smith as Hildebrand pops off the purple and gray stripe.
I think pops is probably a little bit of an exaggeration. I think he was a little slow getting up there. We'll see if that hit has any lingering effects on Hildebrand.
He's taken a few shots in this first half in the Illinois State defense. Second down and 10 from the Redbird 45. On the ground, Blackman, and there is nowhere to go. He is met by Rivera. Alejandro Rivera, quite a story. The former walk-on emerging into the type of player he has been the past 2 years at Illinois State.
Yeah, Spencer Nowitzki, defensive coordinator for Illinois State. He's branded his group the Mutts.
Yeah.
And he says Alejandro Rivera is the truest mutt of all of them.
Third down and 9. Hildebrand underneath, and it is juggled and dropped.
Hey, Hildebrand's pass.
Darian Daniels, who's their third down back, was hit by Harris. Should have made the catch. Might have taken his eyes up as he heard the footsteps.
Yeah, I think Darian Daniels was thinking about running with that football or where the defender was.
Patrick Ponder on
the
punt for the
Bears. He is the third down back, the back with the best hands and the best receiving totals for all the backs for Central Arkansas. Unfortunate drop by Daniels really hurts his football team right there.
Busy first half for Patrick Ponder.
Go get it.
Schnell decoys as it bounces inside the 10. Good special teams coverage downfield by Raphael Garner, and Illinois State will start deep in their own end. 4:25 to go, the opening round of the playoffs here. The road to Frisco, Redbirds by 10. For the first time in school history, Central Arkansas hosting an FCS playoff game. Right now, though, it's the Road Warriors from Illinois State on top, 17-7, Redbirds on top as they set to start the drive from their own 8-yard line with 3:25 to go in this first half. Colby's going to take a shot downfield. Receiver has a step, and he's right over the shoulder. Beautiful throw. Fowler, the speedster, makes the catch as he beat Trey Smith.
Fowler is the deep ball guy for the Redbirds offense. Sometimes when you're backed up, you take a shot. That's what the Redbirds do. Nicely delivered football by Colby. Fowler's able to run underneath it. If you're Trey Smith, you need to have enough of a scouting feel to know that if I'm lined up on Fowler, he is the guy of all the receivers for the Redbirds who has the most potential to try to go deep on me.
It's a 47-yard strike on first down for Illinois State, just like that on the Bear 45. They stretch it right side, but the pursuit is there, and they throw Towns for a loss. Raphael Garner, the first one blowing up the play. Start to look at clock a little bit. Plenty of time for the Redbirds with two timeouts approaching the 2.5-minute mark. Second and 13, they set up the tunnel screen to Gibbs. Shakes free from the initial defender, but the help out arrives. Central Arkansas able to sniff it out. Jordan Tolliver with the stop, third down.
Nice pursuit by the Bears defense. As you said, sniffing that screen out, getting as many guys to the football as possible. We've seen Chris Chambers have a lot of success in these third and long situations coming off the left side of the Redbirds offensive line. He would be somebody I would certainly keep an eye out on this down.
Chambers with a couple of sacks in this first half, number 28. Play clock winding down in Illinois State.
Second timeout, Illinois State.
Uses their second timeout, so we'll keep the action here. 17-7, Redbirds with the 10-point lead. It's a fun time of the year with the FCS playoffs. Winner of this game heads to the Northwest next weekend. Cheney, Washington, to take on an Eastern Washington program representing the Big Sky.
Yeah, and they will go from the stripes, the purple and gray we got out here now, to that inferno red next week in Eastern Washington. Myself, as a former Seattle Seahawk, back in the old days when teams used to go to colleges for training camp, that's where the Seahawks went for training camp. So I'm quite familiar with the lay of the land out there in Cheney.
And in the FCS land, the last team not named North Dakota State to win an FCS title?
Eastern Washington,
2010.
Yes, the Eagles of Eastern Washington.
Third down and 13 from the 48-yard line. Colby looks. Here comes Chambers again. Colby with a wobbler, and it falls harmlessly incomplete. Chambers again cranking up the dial, putting the heat on.
Chambers was able to fight through a couple of blocks, forced Colby to step up, but he stepped right into George Odom. Odom was the one who put the hits on Colby. Again, we see Chambers fighting through those two blocks, and then bang, Odom's able to put his helmet into the chest of Colby and put him on his back. Nice job by that front for the Bears.
Odom in that apex position, the rover spot in the Central Arkansas defense, the team's leading tackle. Punt goes out of bounds along the far sideline by Reese Attard, and it will be Central Arkansas football with a full allotment of timeouts and a minute 18 to go for the Bears and Steve Campbell as they try to get some points before halftime. Remember, Illinois State will have the football first to start the second half.
If you're Steve Campbell, head coach of Central Arkansas, you would certainly love to get some points here, but the last thing you want to do is turn the football over or go three and out and leave time on the clock for Illinois State to pick up some points. So it's going to be a delicate series of play calling here, trying to accomplish two very opposite goals.
Critical drive in this football game for Central Arkansas. Hildebrand's going to go deep right away. It's up into double coverage, and it's knocked away by Coker. They were looking for Smith. Harrison Coker sandwiching the star receiver.
Nice job by Coker going up, blocking the vision of Smith from trying to catch that football.
Second and 10. Illinois State bluffs a blitz, yet they're still able to get to Hildebrand on the edge. It's Matt Swain. Tell you what, the stork, as he's referred to by his teammates for his long, gangly figure, able to wreak havoc in this first half.
We'll see the stork coming around the left side of the screen here. Offensive tackle David Tachi was unable to keep up with the stork. The stork at 6'7", 235. He's got the length, the arm length to keep the blockers off his body and the speed and athleticism to turn the corner.
You see those arms. He's not a prototypical defensive end, is he?
No, not at all. But there's another guy nicknamed the stork who played really well for the Oakland Raiders back in the day, Ted Hendricks.
Yeah.
That body type, I've played with players with that body type. Again, those long arms make it very difficult for any blocker to get on their body. They're able to use their arms to keep anybody off of them. But then again, they're also small enough and athletic enough to bend the corner to do the things we just saw Matt Swain doing that last down there. Defensive coordinator Spence Nowitzki talks about, we want to focus on tendencies. So that pass play on first down to Desmond Smith, I would have to think that every secondary member of the Redbirds knew in those situations this is where they want to go with the football.
See, if Central Arkansas plays it conservative now, Illinois State still has Third down and 19. They will give it to Wells, and he is met by Swain again, along with Bryce Holm, the backup inside linebacker. Redbirds cannot stop the clock with 40 seconds to go until halftime, and Central Arkansas sends out the punting unit. There's a 9-second differential. Sixth punt of this first half by Patrick Ponder. We'll work this game clock all the way down as he takes the snap. It's a running approach, rugby style, a kick. Bouncing ball picked up by Schnell, who spins at the 46 and then is wrapped up in his tracks. George Odom downfield, and that's how the first half will end. Illinois State started quick. Central Arkansas tried to respond, but Coach Spack's bunch, a long way from home, go into the break leading by 10. Steve Campbell joins us, and Coach, another slow start, but you were able to get some traction in that second quarter, especially defensively stopping their running game.
Yeah, we were able to get off the field a couple of times. You know, the first quarter was field position. We dug ourselves in a hole a lot and never could get decent field position. We got one drive there and was able to score some points, and then, you know, defensively we got some traction and we gave up the big kickoff return, and again it turned into a field position deal. So we need to play better on special teams and move the football offensively. You know, we hadn't had a whole lot of luck running the football. Got to find a way to move the football on the ground.
All right, Coach, you talked about the field position. I'm sure that's limited your offense, but how do you get Hayden Hildebrand going here in the second half?
Well, we got to find a way to protect him and then get him some throws that he can make with some open receivers. So, you know, we need to probably continue to stay in a little bit of the double stuff that we were doing and mix in the run in the pass. But, you know, we got to be able to run the football more effectively to keep him from teeing off and rushing the quarterback.
Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Steve Campbell and the Bears with some work to do. They trail at 17-7 here at the intermission, the first round of the FCS playoffs. And welcome back. Halftime here at Estes Stadium, Central Arkansas and Illinois State. Globally, football is soccer, but south of here, Mexico has developed a growing passion for the pigskin.
Caliéntate bien, concentrado, metido, enfocado, disfruta el partido, todo listo, listo.
You can see the importance of American football here in Mexico now. It's getting bigger and bigger.
We know that the soccer is the major sport, but in this season, this to September to February to Super Bowl, people get crazy about football.
Football around the rest of the globe is soccer. In America, of course, football is football. But the world is getting smaller, and to the south, Mexico has developed a passion for the pigskin.
San Francisco 49ers, Houston, Texas, Pittsburgh Steelers, Denver Broncos, Dallas Cowboys, Detroit Lions,
these enthusiastic young fans have more than just a passing knowledge of the sport.
Ben Roethlisberger, Matthew Stafford, Tony Romo, Colin Kaepernick, Peyton Manning, Joe Montana,
Antonio Brown. Business is booming.
The sport, originally brought to Mexico by college students abroad in America, has deep, deep roots.
American football has been played in Mexico for over 100 years. At the college level, back in the 60s, American football was even more popular than many of the soccer teams in this country.
I watch more football. I don't like to watch any game of soccer. It's too boring for me.
Una fortaleza mental que te lleve a atreverte a hacer grandes cosas. Estamos de acuerdo. Usa tu fuerza.
When I was a kid, it was like you feel different from the other kids because you play football, because it's an aggressive sport. Like, I was tougher than the other kids. You would become a warrior.
Recently, another form of football has gained popularity in Mexico, flag football, or tochito.
We have around 300,000 people that play tackle football, and we have over 2.5 million kids in our flag football program.
And this game isn't gender specific.
Yo creo que ahora las niñas tienen más confianza que antes. Okay, que antes las niñas eran porristas y ahora ya lo empiezan a practicar porque les gusta correr y anotar con pases o de otra forma.
Flag football is more popular because there are no contact, so they are more careful with the health of the people, of the players.
After playing in college, where students typically attend and compete for 7 years, there's only one professional league with four teams the most talented athletes can join. While there have been 15 Mexican-born players to play in the NFL, none are currently on any team's active roster. But there is hope.
You have more children practicing, and all, so the base is getting wider. You have a much more possibility to detect talents.
While soccer seems destined to remain number one in Mexico, football is developing a growing foothold in the country's vast spectrum of sports.
One of the biggest things I think that the football gives to the children is the sense of community, the sense of teamwork. And I think what is one of the most important things you have to learn during life.
...17-7 Illinois State out in front of Central Arkansas here at halftime. The opening round of the FCS playoffs presented by Northwestern Mutual. Redbirds in control from start to finish in that first half. And you see the brackets and what's at stake. The winner of this game heads to Cheney next Saturday to take on the number two seed, Eastern Washington. North Dakota represented as the number seven seed. How about the Citadel? And then last year's national runner-up in Jacksonville State. A lot of people like their chances to challenge North Dakota State this year.
Yeah, this opening round is always so interesting. I'm just looking forward to this second half of this game to see who gets the opportunity to go to Eastern Washington and take on the Eagles. So far in this first half, it's been an interesting swing of momentum from sideline to sideline.
What's so interesting about this year's field of 24, you have four teams from the Big Sky, four from the Colonial, four from the Southern, and then four from the Missouri Valley Football Conference. And the two teams that jump out at me, obviously North Dakota State, the five-time defending champs.
Right.
But keep an eye on South Dakota State. They knocked off the Bison earlier this year.
Yeah, when you have, a North Dakota team and a South Dakota team, you can almost call them rivals of some sort. So it'll be interesting to see if they both move on after the second round.
Villanova with a big lead over St. Francis. That's a St. Francis team making their first appearance in the FCS playoffs. For Villanova, retiring head coach Andy Talley trying to go out with a bang. Chattanooga's ripped up a big lead on Weber State. New Hampshire in the playoffs for the 13th straight year out in front of Lehigh, 43-21. The opening round underway. We'll return to Conway after this. Illinois State leads by 10. Yards have been tough to come by here in Conway today. The opening round of the FCS playoffs, Illinois State with a 17-7 lead. The Redbirds with the 10-point lead. They've never trailed in the first half, and it's been a dominant defensive performance turned in by Illinois State. Brock Spack, who knows a thing or two about defense, joins us. And, Coach, you have to be happy with the way you've slowed down their ground attack, just 6 yards net rushing. What's been the key?
Well, I think we're getting off of blocks, and you know, we're tackling well. That's we got to keep doing that in the second half. They're we fit the runs pretty good so far. They're a very dangerous team, though. They have good backs, very good backs, and they have great speed on the perimeter. So we've got to keep it up on defense, and you know, got to take care of the football. Can't turn it over, and should be in good shape.
Keeping the theme to running the football, Coach Bocha, DeMarco Corbin, and Jamal Towns have been great running the football here today. How do you keep that going here in the second half?
Just keep blocking them, I guess. We got to feed the backs and got to keep that up if we can. You know, the league we play in is so physical, fellas. It's just, you know, it gets us ready for games like this, you know. So this is every week for us in the Missouri Valley.
It certainly is a grinder in the first half. Coach, good luck coming up here as you try to make that push to Cheney next weekend.
All right. Thank you very much, fellas.
Thanks, Coach.
Brock's back and the Redbirds, they have their bags packed. They're hoping for another road trip, and they still have a lot of football to go to here in Conway.
Let's go, Bears!
Illinois stayed out in front of Central Arkansas, 17-7, as we get set for the start of the third quarter. It was a Redbird offense that started fast and furious, and it was on the ground. And a redshirt freshman in DeMarco Corbin showing some size and breakaway speed.
He absolutely did, but that hole was huge. Nice job by the Redbirds offensive line allowing Corbin to get to that big hole.
Down 10-0, Hayden Hildebrand was able to get the Bears back in it, finding a familiar target in Desmond Smith, but back came Colby. When you talk about familiar targets, number 82 has been the guy the past couple of years in Anthony Warm at Illinois State. Redbirds with only 8 first downs, Central Arkansas just the 4. Look at the rushing yards for the Bears. They have been all bottled up.
They have absolutely been balled up. They're going to have a difficult time getting their quarterback, Hildebrand, any time and comfort in the pocket if they can't run the ball and force the Redbirds defense to respect their ability to run that football.
Biggest adjustments for Central Arkansas offensively as you look ahead to the second half, if they're to get back into it.
They have to run the football. Again, to ask Hildebrand to stand back there in third and long situations, the Redbirds will dial up some blitzes and they'll be able to make life very difficult for him.
James Robinson, who had a 52-yard return earlier in the game, this time fails to reach the 15 as he slipped. So Illinois State deep in their own end, an offense that produced 158 yards of total offense. And Jake Colby in his first postseason experience, 7 of 12, 84 yards, the one touchdown. Illinois State coughed it up once on the quarterback center exchange.
Yeah, more than half of his 84 yards have come in that one 47-yard reception to Anthony Fowler. So neither quarterback has really lightened it up out there. The Redbirds offense has really been powered by the two backs running the football for them, DeMarco Corbin and Jamal Towns.
So from the 16-yard line, the Redbirds will give it to Towns, and he is cut down in the backfield. Dalvin Simmons from Little Rock, Arkansas, blowing up the play.
Yeah, Towns was trying to cut that football back. Dalvin Simmons did a good job staying disciplined, staying on the backside, making a tackle for a loss. Nice job by him.
Simmons going through a position change this year. Started his career at linebacker, actually played the outside backer spot the last 2 years before they decided to move him up to the line on that DN spot. Third tackle of the game by the junior from Little Rock, 2nd and 14. Colby under pressure, floats, dumps, and it's Schnell who makes the catch. Nifty maneuver, and Schnell torpedoes out past the 25, up ahead to the 27-yard line. Pickup of 16 and a first down.
We'll see Colby step up in the pocket, recognizing the rush coming behind him. Keeps his eyes downfield, makes the completion to Schnell. Then after that, it's just Schnell doing a nice bit of nifty running to the center of the Bears defense to pick up the first down.
Schnell, a former walk-on transfer, turned scholarship as he has found a home at Illinois State, started his career at Ohio. He redshirted his only season with Ohio. His father, the late David Schnell, an NFL player for Buffalo for a good number of years. Colby puts on the brakes and throws a dart right on target to the tight end, Michael Clements. Just his 5th reception of the year, and it's another Redbird first down.
I talked about the size of the offensive lineman for the Redbirds, but the tight ends for the Redbirds, Michael Clemens at 6'7". If he's 6'5", you might not be able to reach out and make that grab, but at 6'7", he hauls that in. another first down for the Redbirds.
Coming into this postseason, 9 total catches between the trio of tight ends utilized by Illinois State. Colby has come out throwing to start this third quarter. They stretch it to Towns, and Jamal Towns picks up 5 yards, thrown ahead by Raphael Garner.
I love watching Jamal Towns runs the football because he's got a complete skill set. Again, he's scat back size, but he doesn't run in that scat back fashion. He certainly can, but through the tackles, he runs with power. We've seen him break a number of arm tackles. A lot more arm tackles than you would think broken for a guy who only goes 5'6", 175.
Second down, here comes Corbin. The thunder and lightning combination, and Corbin still on his feet, still moving the pile. The officials letting the play continue, and when it's all said and done and the dust settles, Corbin, with an act of will, moves everybody 4 yards downfield.
Yeah, that had the look of one of those rugby scrums. And because of the huge weight advantage for the front of Illinois State over the front for the Bears, they were able to mush that pile forward for extra 4 or 5 yards.
Corbin with a couple of 100-yard rushing performances this year in relief of James Robinson when he went down. Torch South Dakota and also Missouri State to end the year. Third and short. These are situations made for big number 27, and he lumbers ahead. First down yardage, Trey Smith attacking low, and Illinois State putting together an impressive opening drive.
This has been an impressive drive, mainly on the ground. We did see the nice reception by Snell to pick up the first down. I talked early in this game about the size advantage of the Redbirds, and now when you put Corbin in the backfield, you know, if he's running downhill and you're a defender, particularly a defensive back for the Bears, that's not a guy you want to see 20 more times as this game goes along.
First and 10 from the 43, and they will give it to Corbin, and the turf went up and grabbed him. The Stripes sensing they needed to give Central Arkansas some assistance, and the purple turf reaching out, grabbing number 27.
Yes, the sidelines are the greatest tackler in the history of football. The Turf Monster is the second greatest tackler in the history of football. It just reaches up and gets you sometimes.
Of course, you never relied on that in your days of Pittsburgh or New England or Seattle.
No. I used the sideline, but I could never get the Turf Monster to work when I wanted it to work.
Second down and 10. Let's see if Colby throws. He will. And he will pump it toward the side. Good catch made by Schnell. How about the concentration? Trey Smith was right there with the coverage. Now the question is, did he get a foot down? I'm going to say incomplete. Schnell's right foot landing out of bounds before he could drag that left.
You think? I'd love to get another look at that. I guess they're not challenging that. But I believe that was a catch. His left foot is dragging before his right foot sets down. No, it doesn't drag. On these field turf fields, you're looking for that spray of the black rubber to pop up when someone's dragging their feet. I didn't see that on that Snell.
Previous play of an incomplete pass out of bounds is under further review.
So they are going to take another look at it upstairs. Brock Spack thinks his guy has the catch. So they will look at it upstairs with the challenge.
I didn't see that rubber pop up. If he was dragging his left foot, he was clearly trying to get it down. I believe he had possession of the football. That's not the question. I'd love to get another look at it to see if I see any of that black infill popping up from inside the turf that would indicate if that left foot is dragging the ground. Well, that shot shows clearly he has possession of the football. And I believe that left foot is, yes, the left foot does tap a couple of times.
And again, the ruling on the field is incomplete pass. So judging by that video evidence, is it substantial enough to overturn the call?
I believe so, because you can see the in-ground, the infield for the field pop up when you look to the white part of the sideline. It's kind of difficult to see it against the gray stripe on the field. You need to look with your eyes toward the white sideline paint. You can see that spray of infield material pop up. I believe this will be overturned and called a reception.
Spencer Schnell has really built a good friendship with Anthony Warham, the star receiver for Illinois State. In fact, he credits a lot of his progress to working out with the fellow Indiana native Warren. The two go back to Warren's hometown in Fishers, Indiana, during the down months, during the offseason, if you will, and spent a lot of time working out together. And Schnell, just a sophomore coming over from Ohio. Warham going out, the senior, and what has turned out to be a record-setting career for Anthony Warham. So those two have built a bond, and let's see if Schnell got that foot down.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Third down.
And that's why I asked the question. I just wasn't sure if there was enough indisputable evidence to overturn the call.
We'll take one last look. I see the reception. I see that left toe on the ground. I'm not sure what they were looking for as enough evidence. That seems to be pretty clear to me, but that's why I'm here in the booth with you and not down on the field in the black and white striped shirt.
Redbirds have been good on third down today. Third and 10, pressure comes. Colby floats, looking for Gibbs, and he makes the catch. Oh no, it was jarred free late at the last possible second.
Fantastic job by Gibbs, doing the Willie Mays, looking over his shoulder to get his hands on that football. But also a great job by Juan Jackson coming across from his safety position to jar the football out as Gibbs was going to the ground.
A promising series comes to a stalemate for Illinois State. Questionable review called. Did Schnell make the catch? That would have been good enough for a first down, and then the near catch by Gibbs near the goal line. And this is a live football as it's bounced around, and let's see if it touched Illinois State first before it hit the Bear. I think it did, Chad.
It did. An Illinois State cover guy tapped it back to prevent it from going into the end zone. Once the ball is touched by Illinois State,
it's dead.
Then Central Arkansas can try to advance that football with no bad repercussions. They could fumble it, they can go backwards. It will always be their ball, at the least at the spot where it was first touched.
Spencer Schnell touched it initially. However, Central Arkansas, familiar position, deep in their own end for their opening drive. The NCAA FCS first round presented today by Northwestern Mutual. An overcast late Saturday afternoon, post-Thanksgiving style here in Conway. Central Arkansas trailing Illinois State 17-7 alongside Chad Brown, a horse. Sean Kinney with you. I brought the Midwest cold down here to Arkansas, Chad.
Let's go,
it's supposed to happen the other way around.
You're fighting through it. Ready to be tough, man.
Hildebrand's going to go deep. Has a man open, and making the catch is Wilson down the sideline. They're not going to get him. Oh, he stepped out of bounds, they say, at the 31-yard line.
It looks like Wilson injured a hamstring on that tackle attempt by the Redbird defender, but a fantastic pass by Hildebrand. We've seen a couple of times today teams backed up, taking a shot. Pretty good pocket for Hildebrand, throws the football up. Wilson makes the clean reception, but unable to stay in bounds with a tackle attempt by Alec Coker. Gets him to step out, and I think he ends up pulling a hamstring on that play.
56 yards on the completion to Wilson.
And that was a exasperated Central Arkansas fan not too far away from our booth, upset at the Wilson injury and him stepping out of bounds.
He is such a vital part, not just to the offense, but to the special teams. He set a school record this year for career all-purpose yards, over 5,400 for Jatavius Wilson. And he provides the biggest pass play of the game for Hayden Hildebrand and really turns the field position around in one play. And he was only inches from taking it to the house as he stepped out at the last second. Slant pattern too far out in front of Desmond Smith, incomplete.
Richard Shane Glass on the coverage. Hildebrand was unable to go through the normal timing on that play because of the pressure from the Illinois State front. Just another beat or two, he would be able to hit Smith in stride.
Guys like Brandon Cox, Roman Gordon, Brady Moore are going to have to step up in that receiving corps. Again, there is just no room to run for Central Arkansas. Matt McCown, the interior tackle, taking down Wells a yard deep, setting up third and 11.
I think if I'm Central Arkansas, I still have to continue to mix in runs, even if we're not successful in an attempt to keep Illinois State honest. If you just try to go back and sling the ball around with Hildebrand all game long, I think they'll get pressure on him and force him into some bad throws.
Neither of these teams bring a lot of pressure. On third down, the pass is dropped. Harris was ready to put the hit on Wells. That would have been a minimal gain. So, bam, just like that, you get the long strike to Wilson. Central Arkansas trying to generate a little momentum, and then two incompletions and a tackle for loss by the Illinois State D.
At the very least, though, they did flip the field and take themselves out of some potentially bad field position. Will definitely force Illinois State, if it's not a long return here, to go the long way to try to score.
Seventh punt of the day by Patrick Ponder, trying to pin Illinois State inside the 20 for the third time today, and he has done the job. How about these two punters? Ponder for the third time, pinning the Redbirds deep in their own end. Illinois State still leading by 10. Nine, 10 to go here in the third quarter. Illinois State out in front of Central Arkansas, 17-7. How about the job by the punters today? ESPN's coverage of the FCS championships continue next weekend with second round coverage on ESPN3. For more information, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 90 NCAA championships. Corbin runs into a wall and he actually ends up in the end zone. Forward progress will have him at about the 2-yard line. It was Jordan Tolliver, the senior from Duncanville. But yeah, going back to the two punters, Adderd for Illinois State, Ponder for Central Arkansas. Those two combined, each with three punts inside the opponent's 20.
This really has been a field position game. That first quarter where Illinois State had their most success, they had the huge field position advantage. Whenever Central Arkansas has moved the football, they've also had some good field position as well.
Second down and 12, they go with the power look up the middle with Corbin. Runs over his own blocker as he went right over the top of Kyle Abeloy. Gets a little bit of breathing room. Trey Smith, the cornerback, in on the tackle. Third down for Jake Colby in this offense. Colby going through the apprentice season last year, learned a lot from Trey Roberson, the Indiana transfer who guided this Redbird program into the national championship 2 years ago.
We've seen Chris Chambers playing right defensive end for Central Arkansas, have success in these third and long situations, getting to the quarterback.
Delay blitz, slant pattern is caught. Schnell has been money today as he's catapulted into the air and thrown down, but he has been a third down specialist this year for this Illinois State offense.
He is the slot guy, that third down guy who Jake Colby is going to look to on third down. We'll see the big hit by Jalon Lofton, but then Snell keeps his footing and is able to fight for a couple extra yards and pick up the first down.
Sat out last year due to residency NCAA rules, but he is having a big game today, moving the sticks. 58 catches now in the year for Schnell. First down, fresh set of downs. Jamal Towns is cut down, picking up 1 yard. Good open field tackle made that time by Garrett Sharp. Mention the safety. Spurlock banged up for the Central Arkansas secondary. Brandon Porter is now eligible to play. He had to sit out the first half because of a targeting call last week in the loss to Sam Houston State. That call occurred in the second half, so the rule is you have to sit out the following game's first half. Quarterback draw all the way for Colby, and he will maneuver his way forward. Lost the ball, picked up by Schnell. A huge break for Illinois State, and then Schnell lost it. It's scooped up by Central Arkansas. Juan Jackson with the pick, and the Bears end up with the football. Oh, my.
Oh, my goodness. What a play. What a play. And what a lucky change of events for Central Arkansas. Get the ball with great field position, a chance to score. We'll see. Kobe gets the ball just slapped out of his hands right there by Ray Sutton. Schnell picks it up, but doesn't put two hands on the football and secure it. Ball pops out for him. Then Juan Jackson picks it up and gets a few extra return yards for Central Arkansas. Gives the ball to the Bears in great field position, their best field position of the game, clearly.
Colby is a guy who doesn't run a lot. Jackson, who is in there for the injured Spurlock and the suspended Porter, comes up with a terrific play. You know what I like about that play by Jackson? He was involved with Sutton with the initial jarring of the first fumble, got right back up and pursued it, ends up with the fumble recovery. Bootleg right. Hildebrand wants the throwback. Takes a shot to the end zone. Tipped away at the last second. Smith was out there, but a Redbird secondary player got a paw up in the nick of time. Good job by Drashane Glass. But it looked like Smith had the front of the end zone.
Yeah, that would have been a 6 points for the Bears if it wasn't for Drashane Glass hustling across the field. Two crossing routes for Hildebrand. Had an opportunity to throw either one through back across the field. But it gave Glass enough time to make a play on the football.
Settled to Smith, turns upfield quickly and spins his way out of bounds. Coker with the usher. Sets up a manageable third down for UCA.
Yes, I think the key word right there was manageable third down. We've seen Hildebrand not have a lot of success when it's third and long. Here with a third and three, and your offensive coordinator, Nathan Brown, for the Bears, you can call so many different plays. You can run it, you can pass it, you can have the quarterback keep it. So many options with a third and three versus a third and 13.
It was a rough start for Hildebrand, but he is showing some improvement as they go up the middle with Keshawn Ledet.
Keshawn Ledet on the carry.
It looks like he'll be about a half a yard shy of the first down. The former Illini, B.J. Bello, with the tackle, fourth and a yard. And this is an interesting decision. A field goal makes this a one-possession game. If you're running the football well, I'd say it'd be a no-brainer. Campbell's going to roll the die again. Fourth and a yard. They go up the middle and stretching ahead. I don't know. This will all depend on the spot, and it doesn't look like they gave him a very good one. Illinois State already heading to the sideline. I go back to that point, Chad. They weren't running the football today. You take the points, don't you?
At some point, you need to win the football game just, you know, up front. And so I understand what Coach Steve Campbell was doing. Hey, fellas, we got an opportunity to score 7 points here. Let's not just settle for three. We can impose our will on these guys and pick up 1 yard. My question is, why Keshawn Ledet at 5'10", 199, and not Jarvis Cooper at 6'1", 245, running that football?
Yeah, we haven't seen Cooper today, the Memphis transfer who was second on the Tigers team a year ago in rushing the FBS program out of the American Athletic. So a huge stop, big turn of events. And Illinois State goes back to work with Towns. Tell you what, if you like defensive football, you are being treated here today in Conway.
Absolutely. We talked early in the game about college football now, and it seems like you need to score 38 points to win. I think today this is going to boil down just to an interception or a fumble or some type of defensive play that will tip the scales to one offense or another. But it's really been a defensive battle minus a couple of big plays out here today.
Second down and 9, a 4-receiver set. They bunch him to the right for Colby. He looks that way, comes back, one-on-one coverage. Trey Smith, the defender, as he tried to lead Warham, and it's incomplete. Pretty good throw there by Colby on the tight coverage.
It was a good play by Colby, but also good coverage by Trey Smith out there on Warham.
Another hit coming from Mr. Chambers. He has put his implant on Colby today. Third down and 9. This crowd at Estes Stadium trying to make some noise for the Bears. Deep into the third quarter, Illinois State by 10. The Bears drop 8 in the pass coverage. Colby fires over the middle, caught, tackled immediately, shy of the first down. He hits Gibbs. And it will be fourth down. Garner with the immediate tackle. You see the big cast on Garner's left arm.
Nice job by the Bears defense. Sometimes when your offense is unable to take advantage of the, you know, opportunity that the defense gave them on the last drive, you guys defense can go out there a little demoralized and not maybe play up to your level. That time they stepped up their level of play, able to get the stop, and will hopefully give the offense back to their ball back to their offense with some pretty decent field position.
Addard has been effective with his pooch punts, pinning Central Arkansas deep. This time he'll try to uncork a bomb, and he does. Gets a big bounce. Smith goes up after it. Trey Smith picks it up. He's giving ground, and he is swarmed on back at the 17-yard line. It ends up being a 70-yard punt by Reese Addard. And if it's not the two defenses today, your MVP clearly with the two punters. 17-7 Redbirds. Illinois State out in front of Central Arkansas, 17-7, 3:45 to go in the third quarter. The Redbirds into the FCS playoffs for the seventh time in school history, the fourth in the last 5 years. They've always had success. Five-time quarterfinalists, two-time semifinalists, and then the national championship appearance and the tight loss to North Dakota State. Brock's back told us he's tried to figure out a way just to coach 30 seconds batter in reference to that heartbreaking national final loss. Hildebrand nowhere to go downfield. He was looking for Smith, but the Redbirds secondary closing all passing lanes.
Hildebrand has to know to throw that football out of bounds. His offensive coordinator has talked about him trying to do too much. This is a quote from Nathan Brown. He gets into trouble when he's trying to make plays. That time he was trying to make a play. Just make the smart play. Don't make a play. Make the smart play. Throw it out of bounds. Give your offense a chance to live another down.
Hildebrand, 10 of 23, 139 yards. He has the short touchdown pass, the only points today for Central Arkansas. Bello comes off the edge. They go over the middle with it, and a bit too far in front of Brandon Cox. Mitchell Breeze, the free safety with the coverage, and the former Red Wolf from Arkansas State, Brandon Cox. Cox had a special day earlier this year when Central Arkansas stunned the Red Wolves, and had to be a special moment for Cox beating his former team. The transfer coming over to play for Central Arkansas had a pretty good run with the Red Wolves, 30 catches, over 300 yards. It was 2 years in Jonesboro. Third down and 10, double pumping, settling underneath, and the ball is dropped. Let's see if they rule that a catch and fumble. I think they will.
I believe he made a football move trying to avoid a tackler in the process of making that move, drop the football.
Dwayne Smith with the reception, and now they start to umpile the mass of humanity, and now the official is going to say incomplete. Umpire coming in with the incomplete signal as we take a second look. I don't know, Jay.
Yeah, I believe that. I think that was a catch and a fumble. He caught the football, secured it in one arm, and started to make a move to avoid a tackler. I'm not sure how these guys are going to define a football move, but that was a football move in my mind.
There will be no challenge. Central Arkansas gets the punt away. High, short kick. Schnell bobbles, but he's able to get back on it. Both these teams living dangerously in this third quarter.
Somebody must have done something with the footballs at halftime, because these teams are certainly having trouble holding on to it. That time Schnell just misjudged the football as it was coming down. Didn't step up enough to cleanly field that ball.
Brock Spack, the 1984 Purdue graduate, Rockford native. When he took over this program, he mentioned how it could be a sleeping giant. He just felt the tools were in place, the resources to make this program a perennial power, and he has turned that into reality. Fourth time in the playoffs in the last 5 years. They run to the boundary side, and there is no room for Jamal Towns. He is wrapped up by Dalvin Simmons.
Yeah, outside of some big gashes they were able to get in the Bears defense early on. I've been impressed with this Bears defense. You know, they came into this game as the number one ranked rushing defense in all of FCS, holding teams under 68 yards rushing. And after what was a rocky first quarter for them, they've really picked up their play.
Illinois State today with 109 yards rushing. Remember, 31 of those yards came on the touchdown run by Corbin. Speaking of Corbin, he'll surge ahead for 2 yards. Wrapped up by Eric Jackson, setting up a third down for Illinois State. And that was the big question, Chad, coming into this game. How would this rush defense from Central Arkansas match the physicality of the Missouri Valley Football Conference, referred to as many by the SEC of FCS football?
Yes. Conference call with the Illinois State coaches, they talked about every week in that conference is like a playoff game.
Colby's going to go deep, looking for Warm, and he just can't disengage. Tyler Williams with him every step of the way. And the experienced cornerback, the all-Southland Conference performer, with a fine play.
Pretty clean pocket for Colby, but with all the hand fighting going on between Warren and the Bear defender, he wasn't really focused on getting himself downfield. All that hand fighting slowed him down. He couldn't run underneath the football.
The biggest weapon today for Illinois State has been Reese Abbott. Statistic to the far right. 3 punts inside the 20. Can he do it again? End over end kick. Fair catch signal 4 by Smith. Near the 15.
Number 4 inside the 20 for him.
32-yard punt. And the defensive chess match continues. And I know, Chad, you're an old defensive guy. You're loving every moment of this, but if you're Steve Campbell in this offense, don't you get the feeling they're playing with fire right now, giving the ball deep like they have the last couple of possessions? But this defense for the Bears rising to the occasion, but how many more stops do they have in them?
That becomes the question, and with the greater size by the Redbirds offensive line, at some point you would think they would just begin to pound the football at the smaller defensive front of the Bears.
Speaking of pounding, they'll try to do that with Blackman. He falls ahead for 2 yards. Spack and Conley.
I'd like to see Central Arkansas just pick up a couple of first downs here. Again, gain some continuity, some rhythm to this offense. Run the ball with a little consistency.
They run the option for the first time. It's a quick pitch to Blackman. He has some space over the secondary. And good yardage for Carlos Blackman. Alejandro Rivera finally able to bring him down. A different look. It's a quick hitter to the boundary side. And good yardage.
I like it. I like that quite a bit. Nathan Brown digging deep into the playbook to pull that play out.
3 straight carries for Blackman. Tripped up by Conley, 2nd and 8. And the trend today for Central Arkansas, when something positive happens, a double-digit plus gain, they go up tempo. They slow it up here after the minimal gain by Blackman, 2nd down and 8.
Let's go, UCLA!
Inside a minute to go in this third quarter. Pass underneath, nearly hit an offensive lineman. Gilberto Garcia, the right guard, might have touched that football, and here comes the flag.
Illegal touching.
Yep.
And here, that's another example of Hayden Hillebrand trying to do too much. The play is dead. All your receivers are covered. You have left the pocket. Just throw the ball out of bounds. He tries to make a throw across the field, and he ends up hitting one of his offensive linemen.
Garcia did not help out his own cause. He was shaking his right hand as if that one stung, pointing out to the official that he touched it.
I think one of the most hardest.
See if Illinois State's going to take the penalty or not.
Illegal touching, offense.
A little bit of uncertainty with this officiating crew right now on this call.
Illegal touching, offense number 70. Penalties declined, Third down.
Result of the play, an incomplete pass. We take another look. An eye on number 70.
It didn't touch number 70. Maybe got one of the other offensive linemen, but didn't touch 70 at all.
Third down and 8, and they swing it far side, nowhere close to Roman Gordon. Hildebrand tapping his chest. That one's on me.
That was clearly on Hildebrand. I believe not only was it a bad throw, but it was a bad choice of where to go with the football. He had no chance, even if he caught that football, of picking up the first down. But now the offensive MVP is out, the punter.
Patrick Ponder on the punt. Digs out a low snap. Real low line drive kick. And it will come to a rest at the 25-yard line.
Ponder's punt down by Georgia.
It's a 44-yard punt. And Illinois State goes back to work in what has been a defensive dominant performance by both teams in this third quarter. So let's go into the psyche of Central Arkansas right now, being a former defender. What was your method of staying up after you continue to make plays and you get no support from the offense?
We have to continue to make plays, and hopefully at some point we can get a turnover or interception and not only just give the ball back to our offense, but hopefully score with it. If we have to win the game all by ourselves, then that's what we have to do. But at some point with the fourth quarter approaching, I'm looking towards Illinois State to begin to pound the football and try to shorten this ball game.
Traditional eye look with Tibbetts, the fullback, and they will give it to Corbin.
DeMarco Corbin
tumbles ahead for 4 yards on what should be the final play of this third quarter. Devin Spurlock playing with that bad MCL all banged up. Doesn't want to miss a minute. We march to the fourth. A defensive battle between the Southland and the Missouri Valley Football Conference. After three, the Redbirds lead it by 10. NCAA FCS first round football presented this afternoon by Northwestern Mutual. Alongside Chad Brown, Sean Kinney, and our entire crew here from Conway, Arkansas, Brock Spack and the Redbirds of Illinois start fourth quarter with a 17-7 lead in what has really turned out to be a grind of a game for both offenses, especially in this second half. No room whatsoever. Cardell Best and this Bears defense stuffing the ground game.
Yeah, both defenses have stepped up really since the maybe the late part of the first quarter, particularly for Central Arkansas. And they've really been on the field most of this game due to, you know, lack of rhythm and continuity of their offense. But they've met the challenge of a bigger Redbirds team that plays in a much more physical conference than they do.
Press coverage on the edge in this third down and 7. Colby with a pocket, floats high and incomplete. He had a double crossing pattern going with Schnell and Fowler. Lofton, the safety in the neighborhood, and Colby and a frustrated Redbird offense right back to the sideline.
Kind of a funky looking play. When you have two receivers in the same area, typically one of those guys is wrong. But what he does is he ends up dragging another defender into that area, taking away from the chances of completion to the targeted receiver. So not a great football thrown by Colby, but I think a mistake by one of the Redbirds receivers.
Trey Smith had a game-changing punt return against Arkansas State. Now the kick is blocked. Taken right off the foot of Adder. It's loose. Picked up. Touchdown, Central Arkansas. Ja'Kari Dillard with the recovery, the scoop and score for the Bears.
Have you seen a game in a long time where special teams have been so pivotal?
It's been a long time. Both coaches talked about on their must list, they have to win the special teams battle. This time we saw George Odom come through, kind of shoulder through the block. The punter's got to find a way, when a guy is not blocked, to still find a way to get the punt off. Gets the punt blocked, recovered for the touchdown, 14-17. Got a ball game here in Conway, Arkansas.
Reese Hatterd, I'm sure, is telling his teammates, I never saw George Odom come. As the soccer-style kicker tried to get the punt off, Odom able to block it. And then the Texas Tech transfer, Ja'Kari Dillard, the sophomore out of Princeton, Texas, able to scoop it up. And special teams, the good and the bad, flaring up late in the postseason. And all of a sudden, it's a three-point game. The kick goes through the end zone for the touchback.
You and I were talking during one of the breaks that Illinois State clearly seems to have command of the game, but because they have allowed Central Arkansas to hang around, this game could literally turn on one play, and then literally just the next drive after we had that discussion, that one play happened, and now we've got ourselves a ball game. And this is the loudest we've seen the fans for Central Arkansas all game long. Definitely getting into it. There's a lot of excitement on the Central Arkansas sideline as well.
These were the moments coming into the season that Illinois State had questions. Roberson and Copperidge last year, when the chips were down, always responded with big plays. Who will step up this year? Colby's going to go to the airwaves, fires toward the side, and a sliding catch
Colby's
by Warham.
Is complete.
That'd be the guy I'd look to if I was Illinois State. Find a way to get Anthony Warham involved.
Beautiful, beautiful route by Warham. It looked like all the receivers are going to go deep. Right as the defensive back started to flip their hips to prepare for the deep ball, Warham cuts it off to the sideline. That's how he was able to create such separation from the Central Arkansas defenders.
16 yards on the first down completion. Colby 12 of 22 for 142. Play fake to Corbin, throws off his back foot, one-on-one coverage. He was looking for Warham again, and Tyler Williams was with him.
That's the matchup that you want if you're Jake Colby. You want Warham, not on Trey Smith, you want him on Tyler Williams. A little bit of pressure coming on to Colby. Nice hit there by George Odom, the guy who blocked that punt earlier.
Odom and Chris Terrell putting the heat on Colby. Such a luxury to have if you're Central Arkansas with these two cornerbacks, Williams and Smith, both first-team All-Southland Conference performers, both experienced. See a lot of press coverage from those two. Second down and 10, it's the delay, and Towns doesn't fool anybody. Dawson Hadnott was right there in the center of the D.
First time all game we've seen a little bit of tempo from Illinois State as well. Broke the huddle, rushed up to the line. Kind of an underwhelming play to run after that tempo huddle break.
The sophomore from Naperville, Jake Colby, third down and 11. From the 39, the Bears rush four. Colby double clutches and Warham dropped it incomplete. Tyler Williams, the coverage, it would not have been enough for the first down, and the Bear defense does it again.
Colby, when he was double clutching, got Warham a little too far inside, hesitated with the throw, threw behind Warham, had to reach behind himself. As talented as Warham is, I'd like to see him come down with that football, but he wouldn't have been for the first down, even if he had been able to complete the pass.
Let's see how Adderd responds after having his last kick block. Central Arkansas does not put on any pressure. They set up the return. Dangerous bounce and scoop by Smith, and he is tackled immediately.
We've seen Smith make some questionable decisions back there as the punt returner, and the coaches talked about this during our conference call. Can take a few too many chances back there. I'd like to see him fair catch more balls and not take the chance. With a defender so close to you, if you don't able to cleanly gather that football, so many bad things can happen. I know Tre'Mont Smith just wants to make a play for his team. But again, sometimes you got to make the smart play, not just try to make a play.
One thing we have to keep reminding our audience, Central Arkansas, without the services of their big playmaker, Jatavius Wilson, he left with appeared to be a hamstring injury on a big reception earlier in this game. Hildebrand toward the sideline, so they will rely on Desmond Smith. Smith gets 13 on first down as he's pushed out by Glass.
We've seen it all game long, but Hildebrand is given a good clean pocket to throw from, is not forced to hurry his throws. He's able to scan the field and throw an accurate football as he did right there.
On first down, trying to run over the right side between the center and the guard, Parkman Garcia, but Illinois State not having anything to do with it. Jason Harris slamming his way down from the edge. Give Wells a pretty good spot up to the 34-yard line, second down and six. Over the middle they go, and a diving catch by Cox. Beautiful-looking grab on a low throw as he dug it off the purple turf.
When you're in a playoff game, you need your players to step up. You need your players to make plays maybe a little bit past themselves. That time, Cox was the guy who did just that.
First catch of the day for Cox. It goes for 12 yards and a bear first down. Hildebrand, a play fake. Floats, took some gas off that one, and he throws a strike up to the 43. McMillan with his second grab. Rivera, Glass, soft coverage, and Hildebrand takes advantage. And here comes that tempo again after a big play. They give it to Ledet, tried to change his direction, bounces inside the 40 to the 39. Keen the stop for Illinois State.
The tempo does two things. The tempo forces the defense back on their heels because it's difficult to communicate in those hurried-up situations, but also limits the number of substitutions they can make for the next play.
Ledet on the option. Second time they went with that look. Remember, they used the option to the boundary the first time back in the third quarter. It went for good yardage. Hildebrand took a pretty good shot, and he's still grimacing in some discomfort. Third and short. Now we have movement by Garcia, the big right guard. But was Illinois State into the neutral zone making contact first?
False start. Offense, number 70. Five-yard penalty remains. Third down.
Not a lot of penalties today for either team. Just the fourth Central Arkansas mistake. Illinois State has played flawless. Penalty free.
Zero penalties. Very well coached, disciplined team. Not the type of team that's going to shoot themselves in the foot. We've seen it a couple times today from Central Arkansas.
Third down. Hildebrand looking right. Floats. Smith has a step. Goes up. And hangs on. Are you kidding me? What a catch by Smith.
Fantastic grab by Smith, able to go up and elevate. Ladarius Newbold is right there, but Smith almost pulls it off the top of his helmet.
34 yards on the completion to the ultimate competitor. That's the word they use to describe Desmond Smith. Whether it's Guitar Hero in the locker room or ping pong, this guy competes. And with Wilson on the sideline with a leg injury, it's Smith who's wobbly, who comes up with the huge catch. And with that reception, he becomes Central Arkansas's all-time career receiving yards leader.
First down.
Late penalty on Illinois State. This will move it half the distance to the goal.
Yeah, that's their first penalty of the game. It ends up being a costly one, allowing the Bears to get that much closer to the goal line.
Central Arkansas has never led. First and goal from the 2.5. Wells, the running back. Hildebrand will check down, look over toward the sideline. The former great UCA quarterback Nathan Brown, the offensive coordinator. First and goal. Hildebrand on that slant. They scored once today on it, and they'll go 2 for 2. Same play, same result to Des Smith.
Now, earlier it was Jatarius Wilson instead of Brandon Cox at that inside receiver with that slant cross route, with that pick route. But again, same play, same result for the touchdown to Desmond Smith. But nice call by Nathan Brown. Hey, if it works once, call again until they stop it, Coach. As a three-time All-American who played
after
quarterback.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, defense number 8. The 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
Another costly penalty for a team that had 0 penalties up until this point. 2 here to finish out this drive. Could Illinois State be losing some of their discipline here?
Desmond Smith, 6 catches, 61 yards, a couple of touchdowns. He just broke another record, but the only stat he cares about right now is that scoreboard. And Central Arkansas, for the first time, has snatched the lead. Hildebrand to Smith. It's been money all year. The Bears by 4. Be sure to bundle up those little Bears, but don't go into hibernation quite yet. Central Arkansas in this fourth quarter behind Desmond Smith. He has set the all-time school record for receiving yards. He broke the career receptions mark last week in the loss to Sam Houston State. Now with his 61 yards through the air, he has pretty much cemented his name as one of the greats to go through this school. And we were just laughing during the break. Where on earth did this last drive come from for Central Arkansas? 8 plays, 83 yards. Des Smith, 2 critical receptions, including the touchdown to give the Bears their first lead. And now an onside kick. The ball rolling. Let's see. The Bears think they have it. No word yet. Bodies being thrown off the pile. Still nothing from our officials. And there it is, Central Arkansas football.
Momentum is one of the most amazing things in all of sports. If they would have tried that onside kick early in the third quarter or late in the second quarter, it wouldn't have worked. But somehow, because they've blocked the punt, now they've scored a touchdown. Things are finally going Central Arkansas's way. That time, able to execute the onside kick, knock the Illinois State cover guys out of the way, and then scoop up that football.
That was Jarvis Cooper, the transfer from Memphis, the big running back who delivered that clearing block that allowed his teammates to get on the recovery. And I think that look says it all from Brock Spack. He has to be wondering what on earth has happened in this fourth quarter. But you go back into Steve Campbell's resume and to see an onside kick in the championship stage is not surprising. He has a track record, especially from his days at Delta State. In fact, the year they won it, he pulled off 2 onside kicks in the postseason en route to a national championship that year. And here, risking field position, in the clutches of moments, he dials up the trick call, and it pays off for the Bears.
Really smart call as well, recognizing they've got the 15 yards further placement on that because due to the unsportsmanlike conduct on Illinois State. So even if they weren't successful recovering the onside kick, they would get the opportunity to, you know, line up and play defense without giving away a lot of field position. A great call by head coach Steve Campbell.
See the concern from both teams as they attend to the injured Redbird, and I believe that is Luther Kirk, who is down on the turf. Kirk, the sophomore from Garland, Texas, the backup strong safety. And there was such a frantic scramble for the ball, and there's a good sign to see him sitting up on his own power. But man, Chad, I know you've been in the bottom of those piles. It's vicious underneath there.
Well, not only just on the bottom of the pile trying to recover that fumble where body parts you don't want being grabbed or grabbed, but just the onside coverage, onside kick coverage unit. That's one of the most physical plays in football. You are a lot of times asked not necessarily to go down and recover the football, but to strike a blow and kind of clear out some space so the teammates coming behind you can. That was a really physical hit on Luther Kirk. Got his head down trying to recover that football, and that's a big blow.
That is a 245-pound running back, Jarvis Cooper, with 10 yards head start, full momentum coming at you. Back to action, Central Arkansas. Can they capitalize from the 36? Hildebrand's going to try to stay hot. He's looking for Smith on a double move. Nothing open, so he's going to improvise. We haven't seen a lot of this. Hildebrand to the outside, and he'll go out of bounds at the 16. A pickup of 20 from a quarterback who's known for his running ability.
Hasn't run very much today, but on that last carry, he shows that he's got more than capable as he was kind of dancing through that line, was still holding the football a little bit low. We'd love for him to tuck that thing away and secure it so it doesn't get chopped out from behind.
Inside the red zone, pushes the Bears. The running back is Keshawn Ledet, the true freshman from Missouri City, Texas. On first down, he will get the call, trying to scrape off to the right. Spack grabbed it onto the jersey, stretched it. Ledet gets good yardage on first down. Gut check time for this Illinois State team that talked about their experience coming into this postseason. They had a wealth of it, and now their defense with their backs against the wall. Second down option, a quick pitch to Ledet, trying to lower the pads and get some leverage, but he is met by Rivera and Spack. And now this becomes a critical down, third down. If you're Illinois State, you must contain UCA to three here.
You absolutely have to. UCA goes with a little tempo.
They put three receivers right. Smith is the slot. Hildebrand thought about going over the middle to Doubs. Now he'll take a shot to the tight end, and it's through his hands, incomplete. Bello had the coverage for Illinois State. Doubs was there initially. Hildebrand did not crank it.
Good coverage at the beginning of the play by the secondary for the Redbirds. Didn't do a good job keeping Hildebrand in the pocket. But as he was running, he's not the most accurate quarterback once he's on the run, unable to deliver a catchable football.
Kicking game has been an adventure this year for Mac Cummins. Barely over 50% on the season. 12 of 20. This one from 27 yards. Kick on the way. It is up, and it sneaks through. It's good. Central Arkansas with 17 unanswered. The Bears dancing in Conway. They lead it by 7. Central Arkansas has rattled off 17 unanswered points, and the Bears lead by 7 over Illinois State. 24-17. Fans engaged in this one, whether it's from the bleachers or the love seat and couch right out of the living room. The furniture along the stripes here at Estes Stadium.
But those 17 points are really powered by the special teams of Central Arkansas, with the blocked punt for a touchdown and then the onside kick on the last drive. Both coaches talked about winning the special teams battle. We often hear coaches say that, and so often it feels like lip service, but this is a game where the special teams have clearly been a huge factor in it.
Onside kick, blocked punt, both punters' ability to pin the opponent inside the 20. Looking for a play, Robinson is blown up there. Special teams coverage by Travis Garrison, the reserve defensive back. All right, let's go inside that Illinois State offensive huddle. Co-offensive coordinators Dan Clark and Billy Dickin, what do they need to do here with 7:57 to go to try to get some composure, some type of rhythm established offensively?
Win on first down. Be successful on first down so you're not facing third and longs, and then guys like Chris Clemens can, Chambers can go around the corner and harass your quarterback.
Colby to the air, dangerous throw, and it finds his man. Schmell makes the catch. That ball seemed to hover forever. Trey Smith trying to follow Schnell, who's been the most productive receiver today for Illinois State.
It's always scary for me when college coaches ask a college quarterback to throw from one hash to the opposite side of the field. That ball takes a long time to get there, as that pass to Schnell felt like it took eternity.
5 of Colby's 13 completions have went to Spencer Schnell. IQ
catches, 45 yards for the Ohio transfer. They will go to the ground. Towns trying to use his feet, gets to the outside. Towns rushes for five. He's knocked out pretty viciously late. Devin Spurlock, a hard-hitting safety, second down.
Just an outside run to Towns. He's able to use his speed to get around the corner, but then gets knocked out pretty viciously, as you pointed out, into the Central Arkansas sideline. But that was a great first down. Now you have yourself facing a second and five. The whole playbook is at your disposal now.
17 carries, 51 yards for Jamal Towns. Second down and five. It will be Towns looking for that cutback lane. Scoots ahead, still on his feet. Finally corralled at the 45 by Jalen Loftin, but not before the tiny senior, the vocal leader of the backfield, picks up 10.
As a defender, if you don't know whether it's going to be run or pass, the first thing you have to do is diagnose the play. Then you can try to react and deal with it. If you win on first down, then it allows you to continue to keep the defense on their heels, not knowing what to expect on second and third down.
They stack up the receivers at the top. Warren's the big target on first down. Colby looks, avoids Chambers. Warren wide open, makes the catch in stride. Touchdown, Illinois State.
I had my eyes on Chris Chambers. He almost was able to slap that ball out of Colby's hands. Was just pushed by the quarterback. We'll see Chambers come off the left side. Almost gets that ball. Colby steps up and delivers a clean football. I have no idea what happened to Worms and why he was so wide open behind three defenders from Arkansas.
We got 12.
I think they're along the same thinking you are, Chad. They don't know what happened to the secondary on that coverage.
There were three guys in the area, but they were in the wrong area. They were in front of Worms, not behind him and able to make a tackle.
A late flag in the Big Sky officiating crew trying to sort it out. Jim Crowley.
Legal substitution. Kicking a receiving team. 12 men on the formation. Penalties declined. Retry.
Anthony Warham.
Come on, Park
just
team!
His third catch today, but two of them have went for scores. 55 yards from Jake Colby. Snap down, the all-important point after by Slattery is up, and it's through. Well, how do you like that? Just like that, Illinois State knots it up, Warm with his second touchdown, and this guy has been a touchdown machine for the Redbirds the past couple of years. We mentioned the 15 receiving touchdowns last year. He now has 11 this season, and Brock Spack's going to rely on his defense as we head down to the wire. Clutch time here in Conway.
Yeah, Warham's been playing his best football the last five games. 25 catches for 425 yards with seven touchdowns coming in the last five games. And again, he's stepping it up here today as well. Nice response drive to the momentum that Central Arkansas took. Nice drive by the Redbirds, able to respond, quiet the crowd, take some of that momentum back, give their defense a chance to go on the field and just line up and play and not deal with the crowd and the Bears' offense.
This was a Redbird team that had to wait until the last possible second to find out if they were going to be postseason eligible here in the FCS playoffs. As Smith gets to the outside on the return, Dwayne Smith, a return of 24 yards out past the 30. Brock Spack told us he was on social media all last weekend on Saturday night. All the experts were saying that Illinois State was out. Their 6-5 record wasn't enough. So he went to bed really mad, really angry. He did not even watch the selection show on ESPNU last Sunday morning. He went to walk his two dogs after church, the two retrievers. And then as he got back close to his house around the 11 o'clock hour, he heard massive screams coming from the females inside the house, his wife and his daughter. And he knew right then that they had gotten the invitation. Cox with the catch, picks up 11.
Hildebrand's
and
pass
a first
is
down.
To
Coker
Cox.
The hit along with Rivera.
So when a guy like Latavius Wilson goes out of the game, you need the next man up to step up. And I think Brandon Cox has done that here, particularly in the fourth quarter.
Two big catches for Cox, the junior, locally grown product right here from Conway, Arkansas. Still lots of time, clock moving inside 6 minutes to go. First and 10, the ball right at midfield. That's Cox in motion. And a steady dose of the air game, and they go right back to the slot. Cox makes the catch, jumped on by B.J. Bello. Second and 6 for the Bears.
Bears continue to not huddle up, not do substitutions, to not allow fresh pass rushers to come on field for the Redbirds.
Neither of these teams bring a lot of blitz packages. They get it done with their front four. That's big Zach Gaugler in motion. Lee Black on this play as Wells goes up the middle. Antoine Wells, who entered today, the second leading rusher on the Central Arkansas team. Really a great story. He played for Coach Campbell at Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College. He tore his ACL with 3 weeks left to go in his final year at Mississippi Gulf Coast. He fell off the recruiting radar of many schools, and he decided to follow Coach Campbell, who gave him a shot here at Central Arkansas. And the senior from Moss Point has put together a productive year. The only player really for the Bears with postseason experience. He'll try to plow his way for first down yardage, but not happening. Rivera, Conley, and the rest of the Redbird D stiffen up.
Sometimes the old football guy in me just hates when you always have your quarterback in that pistol or shotgun formation and not under center. It doesn't allow the running back to get some momentum and head downhill to pick up some tough yardage. He's running sideways before he goes downhill. That time, he had no chance against the Redbirds defensive front, running sideways first in that short yardage situation.
We'll have to wait and see if they indeed punt it, but they have Ponder on to try to play the field position game. Using all of the play clock, gets the kick away. Schnell moves over, decoys the catch, and Ponder has done it again. Look at that, inside the 5, down to the 2-yard line. This has been a punting clinic tonight. Patrick Ponder and the Bear defense back to work. We're in a stalemate, 24 apiece.
To execute more of their offense.
3:24 to go here in the fourth quarter as Illinois State with their backs against the shadows of their own goal line. 24 apiece. What a game here. What a great way to kick off the FCS playoffs. Second and 9 from the end zone. They go back to Corbin. And against the nation's toughest rush defense, there is no hole to be found. Had not. Simmons. Harris all in there for Central Arkansas.
Now they face a third and long. And with your quarterback in the end zone, if you commit a holding penalty against a pass rusher, it's going to be a safety, so it'll be very interesting to see what the play call is for the Redbirds in this backed-up situation.
Confusion and a timeout, I believe, taken
first
by Central Arkansas.
Half, Central Arkansas.
So that's what's called a Kodak moment. You allow the offense to go in the huddle. You see what personnel they have on the field, then you get your proper defense on the field ready to execute the next snap.
For the Red Hat, guys. Jeez.
I'm excited. Maybe because of Red Hat.
2:28 to go here in the fourth quarter. The winner moves into the second round next Saturday in Cheney, Washington. Second-seeded Eastern Washington patiently awaiting. Alongside Chad Brown, Sean Kenny with you on a cool late afternoon, early evening here in Arkansas. Play of the game coming up. Third down and 8. Colby's going to throw from the end zone down the middle. Incomplete. He was looking for Schnell. And Schnell took a late pop, and he's on the turf in some pain.
That blow was delivered by Jalon Lofton. Lofton was going for the hit. I believe he could have intercepted if he was in that mindset to pick off this football.
Yeah, you're right. He had his radar locked on number 11.
Yeah, we've all seen those Star Wars movies where the fighter pilots are following each other and they get that visual lock. I think Jalon Lofton had the visual lock on Snell's ribs instead of going for the football. And Snell definitely suffered the worst of that hit.
Both coaches have operated with a very patient game plan, and that's play the field position battle. If you go back to that last series for Central Arkansas, they were looking at 4th and 2, 4th and 3 from around the Redbird 40, but Steve Campbell had faith in his defense, and that faith has been rewarded. A 3-and-out for the Redbirds, and the Bears should get the ball in great shape with 2:23 to go. A Central Arkansas program in the FCS playoffs for just the third time. Spencer Schnell is up on his feet, walking off on his own power. He's played a whale of a game tonight. 5 catches, 45 yards, but 5 of those grabs. He is one of those guys that lives on third down. They were looking his direction, but he could not make that catch. And now it will be the punter, added on deep in his own end zone. Toward the back boundary. He's already had one kick blocked today. Central Arkansas does not come after it. Adder gets a wobbler end over end. Smith on the back pedal makes the catch at midfield. Trey Smith trying to cut inside is thrown down at the 44-yard line. A return of 6 yards and the punt of 43 by Reese Adder. So here we go, 2:11 to play, fourth quarter, and the Bears with 2 timeouts.
The Bears have certainly had their most success when they go with a more up-tempo passing attack. I expect to see more of the same here. They certainly don't want to go 3-and-out and not take any time off the clock and give the ball back to Illinois State. So they've got to find a way to keep that clock moving, stay in bounds, eat up some time off this clock.
McMillan, Cox, and Smith are the 3 receivers in this package. The tight end is Scott Matiaha. Hildebrand from the gun. Play fake. Wanted to go over the middle. Settles for the flat. Wells with the catch. Antoine Wells picks up a huge block from Desmond Smith. And he'll take it to the 4. 39 yards on the swing pass to Wells. But how about the block by Smith downfield?
Smith leaks out the backfield, catches it with a full head of steam, makes a couple of moves, tiptoes down the sideline, cuts back trying to get into the end zone. Nice job by Wells. But as you point out, it was the great block by Smith that sprung him for that big game.
First and goal, UCA. They'll work all of the play clock inside 10. They take the snap at 8. They run it to Wells as a blocker. Piles ahead. Touchdown. UCA.
Wells taking it, following his blocks, able to cut back inside a couple of blocks to get himself into the end zone. I talked about earlier in the game that maybe Illinois State would wear down the smaller Central Arkansas. I think the second half, Central Arkansas has wore down Illinois State defense.
Look at the smile on the face of Antoine Wells. We told you his story. Tore his ACL in his final year for Steve Campbell at Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College. He was on the radars of a lot of FBS programs at the time. He tore his ACL. He elected to play the final 3 games when a lot of athletes would have went to the surgery right away to improve their status for the next year. Not Wells. He stayed loyal to the program. He stayed loyal to the coach. And in return, Steve Campbell was loyal to Wells, giving him a shot. And will it be Antoine Wells who sends Central Arkansas to the Pacific Northwest.
He certainly has stepped up huge when his team has needed him most to get that quick score. Great job by Wells with the run and the reception. I'm just impressed with the internal fortitude of this Central Arkansas team. For most of the game, Illinois State had the momentum, had control of this game, was clearly playing cleaner, better, more disciplined football. But they allowed Central Arkansas to stay around, and they've got their rhythm. They've got a sense of confidence going now. This is going to be a really tough drive here for Illinois State.
James Robinson from 3 yards deep. He has a 51-yard return already today, and he is boomed at the 20. George Odom on the special teams met the big back, and he delivered a blow. And the Redbirds exactly 80 yards from where they need to be, a full allotment of timeouts. And it's time to find out what Jake Colby's all about.
We'll also get a chance to see exactly what this Central Arkansas defense is about.
Colby on first down. Pressure comes up the center, and he's sacked. Terrence Partee right up the gut. Able to beat Mark Spellman.
Terrence Partee on the stop for the Bears.
Partee with the just bullying. He actually tackled Colby with the offensive guard, just pulled him back onto Colby's lap. Fantastic job by Partee. Again, it's fascinating what momentum can do. Partee couldn't make that play early, but now he's fired up, breathing fire, pushing offensive lineman back into the quarterback for the sack. Great job by Partee.
Saw the power as he just plowed Chad Kanyu right into the quarterback Colby's lap. And this defensive line for Central Arkansas was a question mark coming into the season. They lost Jonathan Woodard, who was a fifth-round NFL pick, to the Jacksonville Jaguars. They also lost Derek Floyd, who was a very good pass rusher, but the rotational combination of Partee, Best, Simmons, Hadnott, Jackson, and Tolliver have got the job done. Second and long, Colby unleashes, knocked away. Williams with the pass breakup as they tried to get it to Christian Gibbs.
Colby was a little late with that football, gave Tyler Williams a chance to break on it and get another pass broken up. Came into the game, I believe, leading the FCS with 20 pass breakups. Add another one to that stat for him.
Brock Spack, hoping his sophomore from Naperville can come up with the big play here, third and 16.
How many plays in the playbook for third and 16?
They rush four, yet they're still able to get to Colby, and again it's Partee reaching that big bear paw out, tripping the sophomore quarterback. Illinois State will use a timeout and try to script up one more play to preserve and keep their season alive. First order of business, if you're the Redbirds, you have to figure out a way to block this front four for Central Arkansas.
Yeah, Central Arkansas is getting it done with just four guys. They're not bringing some exotic blitz scheme. It's just four guys winning their one-on-one battles in front of them. And it seems to be, particularly here in the second half, almost every pass play where Colby's dropping back, that one of those front four for Central Arkansas is winning their battle, either applying pressure or getting him on the ground. Partee has certainly been the guy who stepped up here in the fourth quarter, but in the first half, you saw Chris Chambers was really effective at getting around the corner and getting Colby to rush his throws and getting him on the ground.
Schnell has not returned since he was jarred in the ribs. Anthony Warren will be the guy to keep an eye on. Number 82 split to the top of the screen on fourth and 13. Colby under pressure, hit as he throws, incomplete. The front four got to him again.
That was Cardell Best with that crushing hit right to Colby's ribs. Colby tried to step up. Cardell Best went underneath his blocker to force the incomplete pass. Great job that last series by the front four for Central Arkansas. Amazing job.
Illinois State appeared to be in control. They led 17-7, but it was this special teams play. Odom the block on the punt by Adderd, scooped up by Jakari Diller, the transfer from Texas Tech. And ever since that moment, early in the third quarter, it has been all purple. And Central Arkansas with a statement win for this young FCS program. Remember, they joined the FCS in 2006. They weren't postseason eligible until 2010, and now on their third trip, a statement win for a program. And I say statement because it's against the national runner-up from 2 years ago and against a conference in the Missouri Valley Football Conference that traditionally has been a bully in the postseason.
They do. They play a very physical brand of football, but it was impressive to see Central Arkansas step up the physical part of the game. As the game went along, those first couple drives, they looked as if they were overwhelmed by the size and the physical nature of play from Illinois State. But then as the game progressed, it seemed to be that Central Arkansas was the one beginning to impose their will, play a more physical brand of football, have more bigger hits on the defensive side of the ball, knocking players from Illinois State out of the game. So a tip of the cap to Central Arkansas and head coach Steve Campbell. They really stepped it up as this game went along.
Steve Campbell in his third year guiding the UCA program, looking for his third national championship. He won the Division II title back in 2000 with Delta State. He led the Bulldogs of Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College to a national junior college title in 2007. And here in the spotlight of the FCS playoffs, the junior quarterback Hayden Hildebrand starts the celebration for the purple. And the stripes and the home field advantage here in Conway, and Central Arkansas escapes with a 7-point win against Illinois State.
What an impressive effort by them to go from seemingly overmatched to firmly grabbing the momentum, making all the game-changing plays. The onside kick, the block punt, the pass out of the backfield to get themselves in scoring position late in the fourth quarter, having their defensive line step up and not allow Colby any room or comfort or time in the pocket to pass the football those last couple drives. Again, a very impressive effort by the Bears.
A day that saw Desmond Smith put his name in the record books at the school for career receiving yards. Smith, 6 catches, 61 yards, 2 touchdown receptions, and then a game-changing block to set up Wells on that last drive for UCA. NCAA FCS first-round football has been presented by Northwestern Mutual. So for Chad Brown and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Sean Kinney saying so long from Estes Stadium in Conway, where your final score is Central Arkansas 31, Illinois State 24. To watch this game on replay, as well as other games in our family of ESPN networks, log on to watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. The march to Cheney next weekend for the Purple Bears from Central Arkansas.